Hey guys, yeah, RDC TV here. We know it's the 21st and we see you guys with your capes. We was trying to see if you would explain how you're gonna use your powers for good.
Explain? Nigga, we ain't explaining shit, nigga.
Hey, this the news, huh? Hey, at the days of niggas explaining shit to y'all niggas, that shit is over. I'm gonna tell you that. I'm gonna tell you that right now. But what we can do is flex these powers on your head, top. Yeah. Hey, show them what you can do real fast.
You got it.
Hey, that's only one power he got. That's fine. Hey, show him.
Me.
You up next, though. Show him. Hey, and we call that nigga Folk Flat. Yes, we got hero names. What you think mine is? He's a boy. Hey, you know what it is. Hey, hold on. Let him come back.
Jumpman here!
Stop playing with us! So, now that we got these powers, we want to enact a few changes for y'all. The first thing is, how y'all did us in the 1700s and 1800s, that's how we gonna do y'all.
Wait, what do you mean?
What you mean?
You stupid?
What do you mean?
I said, what y'all did to us in the 1700s and 1800s, that's what we gonna do to y'all. So if y'all did good to us, y'all ain't got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you referring to slavery?
Hey, nigga, you said about us!
You said that! That's all we said! Hey, in them $600 stimulus checks, y'all gonna live off that shit.
Yeah, y'all live exactly.
Y'all got that. Y'all vaccines, y'all doing that shit first. Everything that y'all made us do, you doing. Because how you gonna stop us?
All right, this is the Three Ninjas Podcast. It's anime analysis by African Americans, comic book commentary by Colors. More reviews for me and you, your mom and your cousin too. As usual, I go by the name of Domino, aka Full Metal Smack-a-Bitch, aka Womb Raider.
What do you want?
I got an itch I thought you could help me scratch, cowboy. Wow! Oh, good start.
Aka the Bulbasaur Ambassador, aka Starman, you stun spore. AKA Clark Kente Claw, Dreddy Krueger, Optimus Rhyme, Ghost in a Half Shell, Oscar the Gooch, Space Ghost Face Killer, Inspector Deku, G.I. Jimbo.
G.I. Jimbo, he's gonna destroy everybody for you and you and you and you.
Akuma Matata, Mansa Mufasa, Tony's little friend, Frank Castlevania, Master Chief Keith, Barry Flanders.
Heidly ho, neighbor.
We must protect this house.
Ninja Scroll and Chill, R2-D2 Chains, and last but not least,
Death Note Down.
Silence! I kill you!
And as always, I'm joined by
Hess Jones, aka Dr. Deuce, aka Han Solo Cup, aka Bruce Banner, the Full Metal Alcoholic.
I gotta have a beer!
A Bay Blade, Ivan Uzi, Bernie Big Mac.
What in the fuck was that?
Mace Windu Durag.
You know what I got underneath this durag?
What you got under the durag?
Oh my God. Another durag.
Snack Lightning, Jason Mosa, and Wilson Flask.
And also in the motherfucking dojo,
I go by the name of Bobby, a.k.a. Darth Hater, a.k.a. the Man of Skill, a.k.a. the Juggernaut.
Yeah, it's the Juggernaut, bitch.
A.k.a. Professor Sex, Mag Negro, Bizarre Rondo, Super Saiyan Brohan, Piccolo Escobar, Bruce Mane, Cloud Strife, Melanin Manson, Samurai Black, Michael, get the strap, son, Red Jacket. Campaign Poppy, Bobby McFly.
What's wrong, McFly? Chicken?
Nicholas Gage, Bastard Troy.
I am the terror that flats in the night. I am the low rating that cancels your program. I am
Darkwing.
Oh man, my ninjas.
Yep.
Fuck going on, man. How we doing? How we feeling? How we living? Back in the motherfucking studio. Last episode of the year. Breakout Bobby's all better now.
Quarantine Poppy.
Quarantine Poppy got rid of the bugs and shit.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's Jones, man.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, man? How you feeling?
I'm pretty good.
Got to remind you niggas who the champ was before the end of the year.
Notice how we've been ducking the smoke, though.
We ain't even fucking recording no smokes. What am I supposed to do?
I don't know. I'm just talking shit. I got to talk shit somehow, nigga. I'm good, man.
How's your week been? I know you had a tough week.
It was cool. Funeral was nice. Got kicked out of a restaurant. Which
damn,
was
nigga.
I thought you were about to say you got kicked out the funeral. I was about to say, what?
Nah. Well, we didn't get kicked out, but... So, you know how last Sunday I was like... I ended up not having to leave early just because we black, so we ended up doing
being late as shit.
Yeah, way later than we went. But we went we went out to a restaurant, went out to eat. We went to Jimmy's in West Haven.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but I guess, you know, because of the corona shit, they have this thing where your entire party is supposed to walk in together.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't walk in together, then they don't let people in. So my aunt had came a little after, and like the lady didn't want to let her in. But then she was just like, she just kind of just like walked past the lady. And then she got in. Uh-oh. So then I guess her boss came and was like, yo, blah, blah, blah. Like, you got whatever. She's like, fine, whatever. Like, you can't sit with them. You can't do parties. It's like parties bigger than eight or whatever. Mm. She's like, fine, I'll just sit over here by myself. But then the lady was like, I guess, you know, she was just in a shitty ass mood. So they was arguing a little bit. And then it was like, we was trying to be like, yo, ma'am, calm down. Like, we understand. We was trying to be like, listen, we understand. She'll just
do
sit.
You?
She'll just sit over there. She won't sit next to us. We won't scream over. Like, we won't try to talk over, like, or whatever. But she was like, don't call me ma'am. I'm like, I don't know your name. I'm supposed to call you if I can't call you ma'am.
She called a nigger.
Nah, she was like, no, she was white. It was a white lady. Oh. And she was like, yo, don't call me ma'am. Don't call me ma'am. I'm like, what the fuck am I supposed to call you if I don't know your name? Bro? Like, we're trying to be respectful. She's wilding. And she's like, you people. And then she did it. She was like,
you people?
Yo, she UP with us. So my uncle was just like, yep, yo, let's just go. He's like, he just got up. He's like, yo, let's just get the hell out of here before that.
It was crazy. Hot in here.
Yeah, man. So that was funny. So that was Sunday, but then Tuesday was a funeral. It was nice. It was, you know, it's nice.
That's good, man.
Yeah.
Bob Alive, man.
Yep.
Breakout, how you doing?
Yep.
How you feeling, man?
I've been cool.
Don't cough or sneeze, yo. I'm scared.
Nigga, shut up.
I'm saying.
Wasn't my fault.
I mean, I know, but still.
Yeah, I know.
How you feeling, man? Fault.
I'm good. I don't ever want this shit again, though. Only because it stops my fucking money.
Well, you better get a vaccine then,
nigga. Yeah. Nah, I ain't taking that shit.
Yeah, you taking that shit?
No.
You still?
No.
Even though you had the shit?
No. You know you can get... It's easy to catch HIV, some shit like that, taking that?
I saw that. I don't know how true it is, but I saw
raw sex is easy to catch HIV.
I don't do raw sex. I ain't doing that. No, man.
I feel like you got the same chances and shit.
Nah, man. You seen that video when motherfucker tried to act like he was squeezing a needle in and he wasn't doing it?
Oh, with that empty vial and shit?
Get the fuck out of here,
nah,
man.
Nah, get the fuck out of here. Nah.
I seen that. I seen some chick, she like... Passed out? Yeah, after getting it.
Nah, but they, nah, yeah, like she had got the vaccine that she passed out after. But they explain that if you Google it, they say that, you know, she's scared. Like, it's some shit where she's like scared of needles or some shit.
I did that. I did that.
Okay, I was like, the vaccine don't take effect that quick to where you just shut your body down.
I did that. I did that in the hospital one time.
Oh, you passed out?
Yeah, before she shot me with a needle, I was like... And then I woke up. And then
she goes into convulsions.
Shut up, the nigga whole cerebral cortex.
I woke up and just did like, it was like, because this was around the time in Save Rayfield's when they were doing interns.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then she was waking up. She was like,
nah.
She's like, what happened? I said, oh, sorry. Like, yo, got fear of needles, but
that happens sometimes.
It's nothing I hate more than going to the doctor and they let the fucking intern or like the practicing nigga.
Yeah.
Like, nah, you nigga, real doctor, come here and poke me with this
doctor.
Yeah, doctor. Degree doctor.
Yeah, the one who went to school already?
Yeah, 16 years in, doctor. Come bring your ass here.
I want that one.
Yeah, they were scared as fuck, though. They thought they were getting sued.
They thought you died.
Like, wait, you can't leave. We gotta inspect you.
This nigga, they even got scrubs. This nigga got all Skechers. I ain't gonna put no fucking needle in me.
You gotta have Crocs or nothing.
Yeah, man. Couldn't bring your ass here.
I was getting scared. I was like, I might.
Damn, you don't like needles like that. I mean, I don't like needles either, but I've never passed them shits.
But it's one of those things where
you
I was
got
tense.
Any tattoos?
Nah. Well, that's different. Nah. Not yet.
It's the same shit.
Yes.
Nah,
it's the same.
Nah, needle ain't going in you, nigga.
That's what it is.
Nah, it ain't going in you.
I understand. It's different. It's not going to complete. It's not going. It's going past a certain distance.
Yeah.
True. But the needle is jamming through your skin.
Nah, I can do that. My pain threshold is high for that shit. I'm talking
repeatedly,
about shit going in you, nigga. Like, yeah.
And you've never had shading done.
No.
Yeah.
I can do that.
Shading sucks.
You get used to that, though.
Because it's multiple needles. We get it.
They talk about it in the chat. They know I had the belt. I bought the belt out for a special occasion. Like I said, last show of the year, had to show these niggas who the champ was.
Yeah, I was the champ.
What was? Past this.
And you was never the champ until now.
I was the champ for Mad. No Smoke Fridays are coming back next year, too. I don't know when, but, you know, they coming back definitely. That's not something that we just stopped doing, you know.
Yeah, I'm just broken. I can't.
Shit just got expensive.
Yeah.
Appreciate the gift subs and everything. Everybody subscribing and shit on Twitch right now. If you want, you know, if you listen to the audio version when it comes out on Wednesday, you know, you missed out. But, you know, twitch.tv/3ninjaspodcast. Check us out, you know, later on. Not today because you missed it, but.
For future times.
Future times, yeah. Do that. But yeah, man. Glad y'all had good weekends, man.
Yeah, how was your weekend?
Weekend was cool. Hate my job. You know, regular shit.
Everybody hates their job. I mean, I forget. I mean, I forget what time of the year it is.
So yeah, when y'all ordering shit, think of your local postman, your UPS man, your FedEx man, because he got to deliver all that shit. Then there's snow on the ground on the East Coast. And then niggas just don't want to go to the store because, you know, they lazy or corona. So it's like, we got to deliver all this shit. I've been working no less than 10 hours this whole week. And then maybe till Christmas Eve, I probably still won't get back to normal. Because I'm pretty sure some shit will come in on like the 26th where I still have to deliver some shit. But, you know, no less than 10 hours. But my check going to look all right, though. My week was good minus the work.
I mean, I can say the same shit for my week.
Yeah.
I hate to work too, nigga, but.
Yeah, but, you know, keep subscribing on Twitch. You know, maybe we can not work one day.
Yeah. Even though my next fucking 5 checks is about to be all fucked up.
Oh, yeah.
Well, not 5, but I had to take Tuesday some days off.
Yeah.
Then it snowed, what was that, Thursday, and my job was open, but they didn't plow or park a lot. So I got to work at like 8:30, couldn't get in that motherfucker because they didn't plow the shit. So I left, went home, fucking came back just to see. Still didn't plow that shit, so I had to park somewhere else and then walk over to my job just so I could just get a few fucking hours.
Oh, no. Wow.
Yeah.
Thursday? Okay, go ahead.
And then next week, we get Thursday, Friday off, but we only get paid for one of the days. Same thing for New Year's. So my check's about to be stupid.
Nah, I woke up on Thursday. I saw the snow on the ground. I went right back to sleep. I'm not fucking with this. And they didn't plow my street until 8:30 that night.
Oh, shit.
So I definitely wasn't going no fucking way. I was like, yep, I'm going to just sit here and get some work done.
Yep.
I'm going to just go right back to sleep. You know, catch me a nice little nap instead of waking up at fucking like 5:36. I'm not going to wake up till like 11, you know. Do some normal guy shit. But yeah, man. SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play. Are we on SoundCloud? No, we ain't not there.
I mean, but not really.
Kind of, yeah. Whatever. SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, YouTube, iHeartRadio, wherever the fuck you get your podcast, we are there. ThreeNinjasPodcast@gmail.com. If any of your comments, questions, or concerns, you want your question answered in the Ask a Ninja segment, you can reach us there. That is ThreeNinjasPodcast@gmail.com. Also, you sons of bitches, you. Do not forget to check out our website, ThreeNinjasPodcast.com. Check out everything that's going on with us. We got merch there. We got links there. There's links to Patreon there. Consider supporting us on Patreon. Everything goes back into the show. That's patreon.com/3NinjasPodcast. What else? You know, the Twitters, the Instagrams and shit. Mm-hmm. Update on the orders. The orders are going out this week. That's it. You know, it's just I haven't able to pack shit. But everybody's order is going out this week. So, you know, y'all will get the shit. I don't know when, but I'll give you the tracking number and then it's to your own discretion after that. I don't know what the fuck's going to happen.
It's in God's hands.
Yo.
God's hands.
I don't know what to do with my hands, Ricky Bobby. I don't know. It's off my hands. Question time, man.
Yep.
Hesh Jones.
Yes, sir.
I finally know what the B in Hesh B Jones stand for, too.
What?
Bougie.
Bougie?
Bougie bitch.
Nigga because I eat wings?
Nigga don't eat chicken wings and shit. Kind of bougie bitch don't eat chicken wings.
I don't eat chicken wings, no. Damn, I can't have a fucking food preference, my nigga?
Nah. Can't trust a nigga that don't eat chicken wings. You ain't never had no lemon pepper wet?
No, actually, no. I don't really eat chicken wings. I mean, like, will I eat chicken wings? Yes. Is it like my go-to like food? No.
Yeah, we putting out applications for a new ninja, man. I can't fuck with this dude, man.
I peace.
Yo, so what's the first question we got, right, man?
So this question comes from Cindy Vicks. She emailed us.
Ooh, it's a lady.
Subject line, what do I get this nigga?
What's her name?
Cindy Vicks.
Cindy Vicks.
Yep. Hello, Bobbert. Hey, Dominic. Greetings, Heshier. My name is Cynthia, a.k.a. Cubone Gooding Jr. a.k.a. Wool Mandalorian. a.k.a. Luke Shit Talker.
Why did I think of that?
I don't know. Because that was
Cubone
good.
Cubone Gooding Jr. Why did I think of that?
And I kind
of
want to take it, but...
Nah, that's her.
Yeah, that's like Majin Buu's. That was a good one, too. Yeah.
She owns it now. Quick side story. I met you guys at BlurCon and took one of your flyers. Lost it to earlier this year while I was doing some cleaning pre-pandemic. And I've been listening ever since. I'm all cut up and I put my boyfriend onto it recently and he's slowly but surely catching up. At least once a week, he comes to me or texts me about some funny or crazy shit y'all said and I'm constantly like... Listen, I got through it.
You got this.
Damn.
Nah, go ahead.
I can't stumble a little bit. I've been doing pretty all right with the reading. I'm not until now. I'm not saying good, just all right. Damn, same. I was getting there. Lost my place now. And I'm constantly like, yeah, I heard this. I can't stand these niggas. I'm constantly heard that you gotta catch up. Anyway, my question is about him. So because of the Panda Express, he's been working from home, and being home more allows him to work on his hobbies more. I love my man and want to support him, but this nigga won't stick to one thing. One minute he wants to draw comics, the next he wants to be a streamer. 2 days later, he wants to ride motorcycles, start a podcast, study Taekwondo. Whatever. Yeah, he's going to be
MMA fighter now?
He's going to do everything.
UFC champ? Comic books to Taekwondo?
Yo, he's a multifaceted man. He's a renaissance man. It's 2020, nigga. It's a new renaissance.
What could be watching, nigga?
I don't know. The Christmas is rapidly approaching, and I don't know what to get him for a present. I don't want to throw money into something he'll just drop a week later, but I do want him to be the best him that he can possibly be. Please help. Love y'all ninjas. Stay safe in the panoramic. Cindy Vicks.
Now, the fact that your man gonna listen to this shit and know it's you, that's fucked up.
Yeah, but he mad far behind. There. He ain't gonna hear this until like July. Motherfucker.
Yo, baby, you talk about me.
Yeah, but that was Christmas. That was whatever.
Yeah, whatever. It's mad long ago. Love me. Give me a kiss. Come on. Nah, so what should you get your man, your scatterbrained man that wants to do any and everything?
Organizer?
Yo, get that nigga a whiteboard. True. So he just write down his ideas and shit that he want to do, and then when he don't like it no more, he can just erase it. But I don't know what the best thing to get. Like, what do you think he's good at? Like, what has he shown interest in that you know for sure he's going to stick to, or what is he good at doing? If it's video games and being like a personality, he wants to be a streamer, he can do some shit like that. You can get him like a nice little setup, nice little PC or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, if he wants to draw comic books, if that's something like... Is there anything that he keeps going back to where he drops it then goes back to it like after a while? If he wants to draw comic books, get him like an art set, get him like some stencils, get him some paint, get him some... What the fuck do you get artists? I don't know.
Yeah, but then
books
then
and shit.
Then her fear is like he might just drop that.
Yeah, he
shit.
Might just drop it.
It's like my father. This is why I don't buy my father's gifts anymore. Because every time I do, like, he don't use the shit.
Yeah.
That shit gets me upset. I bought him a fucking soundbar. He don't use that shit. Bought him a fucking can mirror for like $600. He don't use that shit. I'm like, you know, I ain't buying you shit else.
I feel like the podcasting and the art stuff is probably the lowest barrier of entry. Because if he already has a laptop or something, you can probably get him a decent mic for like $30. Mm. That's nothing crazy. And the same thing with art supplies. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I know art supplies can be expensive if you're buying like top level shit. But if you're buying some top level shit, you buy him a couple of pencils and like a big ass pad. That might be like another $30, $40, $50 maybe max, which isn't crazy.
A motorcycle is wild. Don't get shit that's going to kill yourself.
Don't get the chopper.
And then your girl going to be single and she going to be out here fucking somebody else. So what you going to do with your dad ass? I mean.
Imagine you didn't have to go straight to that, but like to his death.
I equate motorcycles with death or like just bodily harm.
Yeah, that's fair. I mean, I understand why.
I don't know nobody on a motorcycle who hasn't fallen or... gotten hurt and be like, you know what, I'm not picking that bitch up again. Like a Harley is cool, cause that's like a joyriding thing. You go, you know, when you like 80 and some shit, you just go with your pals.
Yeah,
niggas want motorcycles to go fast.
I got two cousins that got fucked up on motorcycles. Like one of them fell out. That one of them was a moped though. This nigga fell off the moped and just slid his face into the curb.
Oh, yep. Shit.
Yeah, he was fucked up. This nigga had a piss bottle and shit. And I was like, damn, you got fucked up.
Fuck the motorcycle.
Dad, so,
what? Get that off the list.
He fell on his face and broke his dick?
No.
Wait, what?
He fell hard and then, like, his head hit the side of the concrete on the curb.
Oh, so it's like.
So he was like kind of like fucked up.
That's crazy. Yeah. I'm never getting on a motorcycle. Yeah,
I got one cousin that he was on a super bike. This nigga fell off. All his skin on the side just ripped the fuck off.
Oh, yeah. Can't fuck with that. Yeah, some dude on my block, that happened to him. He was trying to impress some girl. He fell on a moped or some shit. Scraped the whole side of his face now. He's a dark ass nigga. So half his face was like dark. Half his face was pink.
Oh, because it was the pigment that came back in.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
So he the nigga from Naruto? Like, what's the motherfucker?
Nah. Oh.
Black white nigga.
Damn, I didn't talk to him.
Bitch, I'm a cow.
Oh, y'all can't wait for tomorrow? Y'all niggas ready for tomorrow?
Oh, we get our superpowers tomorrow.
About to get active.
Oh, you white niggas in trouble. Fuck all y'all.
Getting active.
Wait till I get my shit. Yeah, what you want? What you think you gonna get?
I mean, I'm probably gonna get some bullshit, but it'd be nice to get like teleportation would be cool, or like some like Havoc Kamehameha way energy beans and some shit like that. Yeah. About to get active in these streets. Or lightning. Just so I can be snack lightning for real.
He just snacks up in the instant. Bam! Yeah. I don't know, man. But what to get this? I don't know what to get him. You know, just see what he shows interest in, like, the next few months. The most important thing is support him. Whatever the fuck he wants to do, just support him. No matter how crazy the idea is, no matter how long he sticks with the idea, just support that man. You know, that's, you know, what's gonna, I guess, drive him to actually stick with something. Maybe.
Yeah.
If he sees that. If don't nobody else support me, if don't nobody else believe in me, my girl believe in me. So I might stick with this. She might see something I don't. So, you know, support is, you know, morale is a big thing. You know, you never know what the fuck he might be good at. If that nigga start drawing and draw some real good shit, then you out of where you out of.
Might be the next Todd McFarlane, you don't know.
You never know. You never know what ideas that nigga sitting on. But
man.
Appreciate you, Cindy.
True.
What's the other question,
Cindy?
We got?
Lou.
I don't remember you from BlurCon, but I appreciate you for taking a flyer and actually keeping it.
And actually listening.
Yeah, for real.
So shout out to you. This next question comes from Mingled Holmes in the Discord chat. Join our Discord chat. You will have random fun conversations in there for some odd reason. The third question goes.
Oh, hey, yeah. Join our Discord as well, please.
Yeah.
I think we need a spoiler section.
A spoiler section?
Yeah.
Why?
Just because.
Oh, yeah.
Niggas was waiting to talk, niggas to talk about Mandalorian.
Like, yeah, yeah, niggas was itching to talk about that shit. Like, yo, y'all gonna discuss this shit.
I understand. Fire, I understand, but shit. Hold up.
I'm just mute that whole channel. So I don't see shit.
You can't see nothing?
Yeah, because niggas watch it like 8 o'clock in the morning. I'd be at work. They'd be like, yo, you saw when? I'm like, no. I actually didn't.
Yeah, that's why I was like, I got home. I was like, yo, let me watch this shit before niggas ruin this shit real quick.
Then you got niggas on Twitter.
On Twitter and shit.
Yeah, niggas spoiled Grogu for me. I was like, what the fuck is this word?
Grogu.
And then I watched shit. I was like, you motherfuckers. If I wasn't so stupid, I didn't know what that meant.
You dirty rat. All right, so, hey, ninjas. I recently have been trying to get to my younger days again. Granted, I'm only 22.
Damn.
I know, so you ain't
nigga, older. Shut up.
I know.
Life hit you
younger days.
I know, right? Days. Anyways.
On the cusp of life.
Fuck you.
Growing up, one of the things that was the shit for me was Bakugan. And everyone had them. But now that I try to find the classic ones, they're stupid expensive and considered vintage. So my questions are, when did you realize you're getting old, even though you're only 22, so you're not nowhere near old?
Nowhere.
And also, what's one thing from your childhood you've wanted to get again and realize is expensive and or hard to fucking find? Also, happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
First off, you're not old, dog. Yeah, I know you're not. I don't know you're kind
nigga,
of joking.
You like a year ago, you were just legal enough to drink. You're fine.
I mean, even though
niggas probably been drinking since.
Yeah,
I started drinking. I was like 13, 14.
Yeah, I think I started. I had my first drink when I was 5. By
damn,
accident.
Nigga,
it was by accident.
You ever had one of those rum candies?
Mm-mm.
I had one of them. Just
nah, it was like the lady that was watching me had a brother who was drinking something dark. It was in a cup just like this. It was my apple juice
and his cup.
His shit.
And you was like,
picked up his shit, drink it. Fuck is this? You looked at it. I was like, that's not apple juice.
Yo, my
daughter, I like it.
Yo, my daughter.
Nah, I didn't.
My daughter almost did that shit. She's like, scared the shit out of me. Good thing she smells shit before you taste it.
She's like, what the fuck is this shit?
She's like, oh, what's this nasty stuff?
Nah, my dumb ass ran out.
This dad juice.
What is this? Nah, but
happy time juice,
man. Yeah, for
happy
real.
Happy time juice.
When I realized I was getting old, when I started hating noise, like,
yo,
like
what, noise?
Unnecessary noise bugs the shit out of me now. Like, I hate when like niggas is just loud for no reason, or it's just shit going on for no reason. I'm trying to like just rest and relax. When I started looking at like younger kids and like when like younger kids are in a group. Mm-hmm. And them niggas just be wilding for no reason. That shit kind of pisses me off too. Like, yo, what the fuck? Why y'all so wild? And I was like, damn, I was 16 too.
I used to crotchety old nigga.
I used to do that. Yo, I am going to be the get off my lawn nigga.
I believe it.
Like, you ass. Mr. Wilson, nigga.
Wilson. When my body's just start hurting for no reason.
Yeah.
Like, I slept wrong. Like, I fucking went to sleep, wake up, and my neck now fucked up for like 3 days.
My neck.
Like, I was just asleep. Back. All I did. Like, all I did was sleep. Like,
all I did was sleep.
Why my neck hurt?
Niggas with their pants sagging, that pisses me off now. I'm like, yo, nah, put your pants off.
Because they got to be over with, man.
Because they be doing it extra.
OD. Yeah. It be like, skinny jeans to mid-thigh.
Yeah.
I be like, dog.
That's my part. Because like, I sag my pants and like, I be like, but why is like, why? Like, it be extra.
Yeah.
Like, yo, your whole ass is out right now. Why?
Whole ass.
Like, what the fuck?
That shit looks like a saggy diaper.
And then they wear, like, a fucking a baby tee. So it's like, nigga.
Oh, my God.
Like, what are you doing? At least when you used to do, you had a fucking tall tees, fucking sag, yeah, but you couldn't fucking
see. Yeah, you couldn't tell shit.
Yeah. Fuck. Put your pants up, nigga.
Put your pants up, stupid nigga.
Be respectful.
When trends start coming back. Like do-rags with the flap out. We used to rank niggas for that. The fuck?
Damn. When niggas think they invented some shit, like, I know, right? We used to do that shit back in 03.
Yeah,
I sound like an old nigga when I, spell, yeah, when right? I say that shit.
Oh, shit, 03.
Yeah, and that was 03, nigga.
Yeah. It's just, like, yeah, basically looking at young people.
Yeah, funny, yeah.
Because, like, the whole Meg thing, right? Remember we were talking about Meg being in the anime, and she said her first thing was Inuyasha? Mm. I was like, damn, like, she was, like, 9 years old when that shit came out.
Yeah, man.
I keep forgetting, man.
I know.
Damn.
What about you, Hesh, when you realized you was an old nigga?
I mean, besides the body pain, I mean, that went bald, nigga, that didn't help.
Yeah, the bald.
You know, I was like, oh, well, this
nigga,
is,
don't blame
this
it on my age, nigga. You was like 20-something when that happened. No? We went bald?
Yeah, it was like 28. Like, towards the end of it, it wasn't like 22.
Yeah, because Hesh had dreads for a little while.
Dreads. Oh,
you
did? Yeah.
Oh, so that really is nigga Hesh.
Yo, y'all gotta come by back, maybe get your hair back.
Oh,
you split like fucking Bigelow. That's what that
was. Yes, I'm telling you. That's his counterpart.
No wonder why you're depressed. That's your happy side.
Oh, shit.
That's the nigga's happy side. They gotta enjoy it back.
That's what I told him. Yo, that nigga get the vitamin D. That nigga look all vibrant and shit. This nigga all dead and dark, back to black.
Oh, shit.
But,
it all makes sense now.
It all makes sense now. Yes, Hesh had dreads.
Yeah, he split.
Hesh was locked out here. Then the nigga went bald and just yeeing the whole shit off.
Yeah, I wasn't gonna be around here like Stevie Wonder, nigga.
Oh nah, that shit was egregious.
Even though if I'm being honest with you, it wasn't that bad. I could have kept it going a lot longer. Probably even till like to this day, I probably could have still probably kept it going, but I was like, nah, I'm not. I'm
what done. You got the sunroof?
Yeah, it's like up here, ain't all that. But my hairline is straight. Like my hairline is high, but like it's just like up here.
Oh, that's the easy thing.
It don't grow, but yeah. But it's like this right here don't really do it. But that's what I'm saying with the dreads. I probably could kept it going a little longer, but then I was like, whatever.
So you could have had the dreads in like a bun and like
or something. I could have, but I was like, man, fuck it. Good. I want to be like Stevie Wonder, so I was like, I'm not doing it. Like, I refuse.
Stevie Wonder got the leaving wide, like that shit.
Yeah. I was like, I refuse to like walk around here like
you
that.
You don't give a fuck, man.
Yeah, you can't see.
He can
solidified.
See.
Yo.
That nigga should play basketball.
You wonder cannot see you.
Yes, you can, nigga. That's he gonna see tomorrow, nigga.
Yo, yeah. Yo, like that Daredevil. Nigga get his powers and he can fucking see all of a sudden.
Oh, he'd be like Daredevil, nigga.
I swear for a look. He gonna be like Daredevil. And what was the other question? What vintage toy do we...
Or just something from your youth dem that is either hard to find or expensive to get now.
First thing that comes to mind is that Charizard card.
Yeah,
because when I was in 7th, 8th grade, that car was $150.
Yep,
for real,
it was $150 for that car.
Why?
Because
rare.
Because Pokemon had just come out. The game had just come out. Then the trading cards had just came out, maybe like a year or so after. And then I remember you used to try to open a pack to get one, but you know, if you didn't get one, you could go to like a store and buy one for $150.
Oh man!
Now that I got a job. And I got $150. Now that bitch is like $200,000, $300,000 and some shit. So I was like, damn, I gotta wait another fucking 20 years to get the shit.
Buy $200,000 to buy like Logic.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that's the fucked up thing. And I had most of them cards too. That's what be pissing me off.
Yeah. I still got them. I just don't got the Charizard.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? The only reason why I lost them shits is because somebody stole them.
Nah.
Like we was in a class or whatever, flipping through the book, and then the teacher took it. And then everybody
you
knew
you got robbed.
Yeah, you got robbed. They stole my shit.
Yeah. I remember niggas used to bring their cars to school and I was plotting on a couple niggas.
You had to do it to them, niggas.
Like a Team Rocket.
I was like, I'm going to get that Lapras.
Blasting off again.
I do want, it's certain like Ninja Turtle toys that I want that I don't have all the parts to anymore. Mm-hmm. I'm missing like an arm or like a leg or some shit, but I still got the toy. If I could get those, that'd be cool. I'm looking for like a Technodrome, and I can't find one. I'm pretty sure I could go on like Amazon or eBay and find one.
Yeah.
It's
gonna charge you crazy.
Probably. Yeah, it's like for some shit that my grandfather bought me for $28. Now that shit $205. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
I
don't really do a whole lot of collecting, sir. I haven't really been like researching, looking for things that I want that was from my youth, but I do know off the top of my head, I do want to like get some of the old consoles I used to have, because I was always strapped for cash. I would always like trade in stuff to get other stuff. So I don't really have like a whole big collection of that stuff, but that's stuff I kind of want to do. Like, I want to get a Dreamcast again and get a Sega and get a Nintendo, get an N64 and shit like that. Get a few games for that.
Yeah, I still got my Game Gear. I still got all my Game Boys. I got PlayStation 1 through 4. Mm-hmm. Still got my Dreamcast. I need an Xbox, like the original Xbox. Because I broke that shit.
Because I
lost the power cord and there was a game stuck in there and I was trying to play it on my 360.
Yeah.
And then I tried to like break the fucking, with a screwdriver, and then it just looks fucked up now and busted. Yeah. I could probably just buy a power cord and just get this shit out. But yeah, I want a Virtual Boy. I want a
that shit give you
a fucking Jaguar.
Damn, I forgot about Jaguar.
Yeah, I want a Jaguar. I want all them Sega CD. I want one of them.
Word.
But them shit's probably dumb expensive. I'm pretty sure you can go to one of them retro game stores and buy them.
Oh
shits.
Yeah, they got that.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure they got them somewhere. I just don't know the prices for them.
They got one in Norwalk, matter of fact.
There's one in Norwalk and one in Milford.
Mm.
What is it? Game Exchange?
Nah, it's the actual like retro game.
Yeah,
plus,
retro gaming plus.
Yeah.
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 My ex broke my PS when I was distraught. I would be too.
Yeah, for real.
That's fucked up.
Yeah. Why she your ex?
Yeah, exactly. Fuck that bitch. Mm-hmm. She ain't know the future. What's the next question we got? Last question we got that we're gonna answer for the year.
All right.
Anything else we got, we'll answer next time we hear, maybe.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Yeah, we'll see. Anyway, so this question comes from that's what making sure this is the right one. That's okay. Yeah. This question comes from Dion, also in our Discord chat.
Sign up for our Discord, please.
Yeah, do that. And his question goes, what's good, my ninjas? It's your boy, Lord Dion, a.k.a. the Asthmatic Assassin. So I got broken up with this week. And the girl said we'd probably be better as friends. Now, she's not the type to sugarcoat or anything. But why does this feel like a friend zoning situation?
Because she literally put you in a friend zone.
I keep hearing this from girls. I keep hearing this from girls I've dated when they break up with me. And I don't really know if it's something I'm giving off that makes them think that we'll be friends or if it's courtesy. How do y'all, as older men, I'm 24, feel about this? And how do y'all handle / deal with breakups? I'd like to ask if y'all plan on covering Attack on Titan or Power Book 2. It's actually not that bad. Keep it the good work, y'all, and stay safe.
I don't believe you about Power Book 2. I'm not watching that shit at all.
I
gave the fuck up.
Yeah, I don't want to get sucked back in.
Nah. Yeah, nah. I have yet. Even though I've also heard that Power Book 2 is not that bad, I'm probably never
like watching. I should watch it for Method Man just because that's my nigga. But not even him can make me watch that shit. I'm like, nah, I'm good.
Nah, bro. Just the way that last season, well, the last couple seasons, it kind of left a bad taste in my mouth.
You struggled through that shit.
Power. We were just doing it because we started it. And then,
I was like, niggas brought in Cedric the Entertainer just to kill him.
Fact.
You know
off
what?
Camera,
I'm done.
Too, I feel like, right?
Yeah, it was off camera. Yeah.
Yo, before they even showed it was him, I was like, yo, the nigga they killed looked like Cedric the Entertainer. And I was like, is that Cedric? Wanted to be him.
It was, yeah.
Oh, fuck.
He asked, how do we deal with breakups and why you keep getting friend zoned?
Yeah, why do you
nigga,
think?
Nigga, the energy you keep putting out there is friendly. Stop being, be a man.
What, did he stick it in?
We don't have all those informations, so I can't say one way or the other for that.
But it's something about the energy you're putting out there with these women that they keep friend-zoning you. And I guess you just give off buddy-buddy, we can go to the movies and, you know, that shit type of vibe. You don't give, like, security, you know, picket fence, doghouse, marriage, you know.
They just don't want that shit.
You can provide. I don't, nigga, I don't know.
Not at 24 either.
They don't, man.
Not at 22, 24.
Yeah, not at 24. Hell
also, I think more so it's, she keep you in the back pocket, right? Yeah, I think it's like, oh, let's be friends while she can go get dick down with some
nigga.
And then come back and be like, oh, we're friends. Let's go revisit this.
Be in a relationship with me, then break up with me, and then keep me in the back pocket.
Yeah, but I think that's what she's doing, right? Isn't that like,
leave
me all the way alone?
No, she's not keeping the back pocket. She's like, us in a relationship ain't clicking.
Yeah.
But you a cool-ass person.
So we just gonna be friends?
So we just gonna be friends.
Until I decide that we're not gonna be friends
anymore?
That
that's mad cool. I would like to be their friend. It's just like we didn't end on the best of terms, so it was like, nah, fuck you. But like, a few of them like, yo, you cool as hell, minus the bullshit that you was doing.
Mm.
We should be friends, but you know, like it happens like that.
So what should he do to like prevent that from happening in the future?
Get to know yourself better. Find out what the commonality is and why these chicks keep breaking up with you and putting you in the friend zone. You know, how do you deal with breakups? You just got to mull it over. You gotta go through it. You're 24, my nigga. You got a lot more heartbreaks to come. Like this shit ain't over.
Damn. I wish I had more information to go off of.
Not yeah, there's that. Not a lot of information, so it's like hard to tailor the information.
The nigga keep getting in relationship, and they keep breaking right up with them. That's it.
But I mean, but that's just like dating. Like you meet somebody, yeah, that's just dating, and like so I don't know what makes this feel different or like it's more of a problem.
Now, without the information, it just keeps happening. Though, it's like, yeah. What do you think the problem is? I'm not a psychiatrist.
Is it playing the nice guy role?
Yeah, that could be it.
That could be it too.
But we don't know, so can't say.
Yeah, sometimes you gotta be a dick.
Yeah, you gotta. It's a balance in a relationship that you haven't found yet.
I mean, yeah, I think that's probably.
Oh, women be wanting the Fonz. they don't want the Urkel.
That'd be cool.
Nah, yeah. Well, women from teenagers to like 29, they be wanting to have fun. 30, that's when they be like, all right, I'm tired of these rough niggas going to jail.
My ovaries drying up. I got to find a nigga.
Yeah. I mean.
All right, that was a little much, but it's kind of truthful.
I should get Lenny on the show. Like, yo, what the fuck do women want?
What these women want from a nigga?
Fuck. Yeah, man.
I don't think we helped you, but
yo, G, make this mic. Yo, Lenny, I need you.
Oh shit,
Lenny, come here. Dude. Here comes a new challenger. I need you real quick. So we had a question, right, from one of our listeners. So yeah, this guy, he's 24 years old. He keeps getting relationships, but he keeps getting friend zoned. He doesn't know why he's getting friend zoned, but it just keeps happening. Now, why would a woman date someone, break up with them, and friend zone them? In your opinion?
Obviously she's dating someone already, or she went back to her ex, or
oh, so she's a whore. Damn.
We coming out, huh?
I mean, you gotta go by the actions. Like, if someone just friend zoning you and not interested, then.
So every girl he get with is just like, nah, I'm going to this other dick. It's like, nah.
Oh, it's every female?
He said it's more than one.
Yeah, the way he presented it seemed like it's a reoccurring problem.
Yo, this chat is wild.
I mean, is he coming on too strong that he's pushing the females away?
Could be.
Yeah, that could be his problem. He needs to start being an asshole.
But
see? It's something about that I don't give a fuck attitude that men give off that women like for some fucking reason.
No, don't leave, but come back.
It's not even that. It's like also like we kind of like the challenge. You don't want someone that's all up in your face and you just met them like, you don't even know me.
But women will say that shit, but they'll say some shit but then don't want you to do it, but then kind of do it, but then not as much but more than a lot. I don't know.
I mean
maybe it's a balance,
like a test, maybe
a test, I guess.
I didn't do good in school.
Exactly. I failed.
Oh shit. I mean, I hope he helped you. Who was that from? Dion?
Yeah, Dion.
Hope he helped you out a little bit. Hope you're listening.
Yeah, so be a jerk.
Yeah, you gotta be an asshole a little bit.
Just
a little bit. You gotta...
No, semi-jerk.
Semi-jerk.
Yeah. Yeah, but what if he's a nice guy? What if he does? What if that's not his nature?
What's a nice guy, though? Like, that's...
You tell me what's a nice guy. Like, we could be doing all the nice shit. We could, you know, call you every day, bring you flowers, you know, just be extra nice and caring and loving. It's like, nigga, you soft.
I know, but it has to be like, you can't go full throttle. In the beginning.
In the beginning.
Right?
So you got to build up some equity. So it's like, all right, so we cool. Then I could be like an asshole towards like the middle of the relationship.
I know, like, I get turned off if it comes forcefully. Like if it's too much too fast. At least let me meet you halfway.
Okay.
Like, you know,
that's understandable.
And then you just ghost them if they're
God
damn. They even get the courtesy to tell them what.
Yeah, like, like, nah, I don't like you. Just stop talking to them, change your number, block them. I hate that shit.
Damn.
But happens to the best of us. Thank you, Lenny.
Oh my God, how do you guys do this all the time? This is so nerve wracking. My anxiety level is like.
Is it why? Yeah. No, this is, I don't know. I mean, we've been doing it for three years now.
So.
It was bad on the spot.
I was tuning in. You guys are good.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, we try. Fan.
But yeah, I mean, you can hang out if you want. You know,
you guys don't want my opinion and shit. I'm single. They do not want my advice.
Unless you like geek shit, you know, other than that, you know.
I mean, I like guys that are geeks, but
oh shit,
Bobby's single. Hey, Bobby.
Nah, don't put me out there like that.
Nah, he looks young.
Young baby face. See, that's why I got this shit. See, now I'm 34.
Are you 34?
Yeah, I'm 34. I'm almost
40. Okay, no, I actually want them younger.
Oh damn!
It's like I mold them.
I can. Yo, mold who in the chat?
Yo.
Dion, you in the chat?
Lindy got a podcast coming soon. She funny as shit.
I don't want anyone with baggage. Okay. over 30 usually has baggage.
I got baggage. What the fuck? Yeah.
Everybody got baggage. Yeah.
Baby mama drama?
No, I don't got that.
Oh.
I got a kid though, but I don't got that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not yet.
No, I don't got that. I wish he would. I wish he would. I do too good.
Oh man.
Oh doctor.
All right, so let's get into the
he's like, show yourself.
Damn, son.
She ain't even ready to show now.
Nah,
chill.
Can't.
Yeah, chill now. Nah.
She good.
How is this sitting on your head?
Oh, you gotta.
I have a small head.
I mean, if you push him down, it's a click.
Okay.
In.
Yeah. All right, yeah. I'm a little slow.
I love Lydia. Oh, yo, that's some crazy shit. Lenny is my girlfriend's cousin, and I didn't know she was gonna be here.
Oh, shout out to Carla.
Out of nowhere, just here. So let's get into the motherfucking review. So Mandalorian.
Mando went to Bando.
Mando, the motherfucking Lorian. Mm. Did you cry, Bobby?
Yeah.
Can't lie. Got a little emotional watching this shit. Didn't like it. Grown ass man watching TV at 4:30 in the morning by myself. I felt like I needed to be held.
Yeah,
a little bit. I was like,
that bad?
Yeah,
I was by myself alone and shit. But so Luke Skywalker.
Yeah.
Oh, back in this bitch. Right in
yeah, you going right into the.
I mean, hey, if you ain't watch it, hey, spoiler.
I mean, obviously.
I don't know.
We.
But how does episode start?
It started with, what did it start with?
The scientists
off the ship.
Yeah, so he was traveling with some other people and then he got stopped by the Mandalorian.
Yep.
And they shot the two pilots.
Yeah, well, him and Kara. And he was like talking shit.
Yeah, he was because talking shit. He's like,
I was on the Death Star. She's like, which one?
Yeah.
And he was like, man, and then he's like, and he made a good point too. He was like, there's mad people on the Death Stars when they blew up and shit.
Yeah.
And nobody gives a fuck. They was all celebrating mad death. I was like, oh, you know what?
Right.
Never thought about that.
Yeah.
And then he was like, well, that's why you're playing that guy blowing up, bitch. And then he shot him in the face.
Shot him right in the fucking face.
He's like, blah,
blah. Oh, shit.
So then they take the scientists. Yeah. They bring him aboard the ship, and now he lets them know where exactly Moff Gideon is on the ship, like where the dark droid. What the fuck? They're not dark droids.
Dark troopers.
Dark troopers. He lets them know that they are on the ship, and they're like, you know, stormtroopers on crack.
Basically.
They not humans in suits. Them niggas is like real. Them niggas made out of like plutonium or some shit. Like, them niggas wreck shit.
So they
get on the ship.
Oh, first off, went to the...
Cantina.
Yeah.
Okay.
To get Bo-Katan and then, you know, Sasha Banks.
Yeah, Sasha
and
Banks.
And Boba Fett got into it because they were talking mad shit to Boba Fett. They was like, yo, you a test tube, baby.
He is. Okay, yeah, no. So I don't know Star Wars lore like that. So all these motherfuckers is clones. Who's the original?
Jango.
Who
are they clones? Jango Fett.
Jango.
Okay, so how many clones are there out there as of this, like right now?
Well, most of them are probably dead by now.
I know of four.
So the original stormtroopers were all clones off of Jango Fett.
Wait, when Boba said that's my daddy shit, it was like, that's not his daddy?
It is because he's the only one. So the rest of them were like, I think, aged up.
Yeah.
He actually raised Boba.
Oh,
like
okay.
From a kid. Like, yeah. So like he raised him as his actual kid.
Got you.
Yeah.
Okay.
The rest of them, I think they just like aged him up or some shit.
Yeah, they had accelerated aging.
Yeah.
And they had the Order 66 chip in their head.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And Boba was the only one that was like, not a natural bird, but he was like the normal one.
Mm.
Like he had his own consciousness.
The normal one.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he didn't like grow up like the rest of them.
Yeah. Okay. That shit was kind of ill though. She was like, I know you are. I heard your voice so many times.
Yeah.
He was like, mine's about to be the last one you hear.
Yeah, I know. Right?
He got like Rocket DDT.
Yeah. I like how they did the wrestling move.
Yeah.
On the show. I was like, all right, Sasha, what the fuck she's supposed to be there for? So then they scoop everybody, they get to the ship, and
they fake the They faked the hijacking.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. Bo-Katan, I think Bo-Katan, like all the females was on the ship.
And then
so,
Mando.
Yeah. And they faked the heist. Boba Fett was chasing the ship.
Hot?
Yeah, a little bit.
With his brightest lights. Yeah, the fire
it's
lights.
It's not even a light. Yeah. Yo, G, I need some cool.
I need some cool.
Are you Jamaican?
Need some cool.
It came out wrong. I was thinking about Arnold.
I don't know why that happened.
I was thinking about Arnold.
Yeah, I need some AC.
But yeah, so they landed. Mm-hmm. And then, so they made a plan because they know about the Dark Troopers. So Mando had to go stop the Dark Troopers.
But before the fight with the girls, girl fight, with Ming-Na Wen.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's.
Carly, oh, yeah.
Oh, that was separate.
Wait, did they? Because they were doing that at the same time.
Yeah.
Because they went to go take the bridge while he went to go stop the Dark Troopers.
Right.
Down the way there, it was like all four of them, all four women just shooting everything. That's one shot, one kill. Yeah.
No damn problem.
Yeah, one shot, one kill, though.
Mm. You know how sometimes niggas be getting mad at females. Oh, the female do that, but nah, I ain't no way to complain about that.
Women on screen.
How do women know how to shoot a gun?
Oh, it's not the woman DeLorean.
The woman DeLorean.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. There's
gonna be a lot of that.
Right? Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
And then,
the Dark Trooper fight?
Yeah. So then he goes to the because I guess they gave him like a cylinder that would like. Lock the doors, but he just barely made it because they was booting him up because they take a while to boot up. So he got there, one got out, beat the shit out of him.
Like, why did these motherfuckers take so long to boot up?
Because they need a lot of power in it.
My nigga, I mean, they've made Death Star shit that blow up planets. You telling me you fucking robots got a boot up time?
Well, they just made it, so.
Also plot convenience, nigga. Really, if you want to be honest.
Like, I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
It should be on.
It's like.
Wartime.
You got to charge your phone, you got to charge the robots.
So these droids are different.
My nigga, I didn't make that. Apple didn't make Death Star.
And it's made by Stadia. Yeah. He's a Stadia Death Trooper.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Oh, shit. So he fights. So one makes it out. One and makes he beats the shit out that nigga.
Mm-hmm. He was concussed.
Yeah, he must have had a concussion. Because he was like punching nigga right in the shit. And his helmet was like pushing through the fucking wall and shit. He was beating the shit out of that nigga.
He got a conclusion.
Conclusion.
Oh, shit. So then... What happened?
That's funny.
Oh, so then he killed that one with the spear.
Beskar spear. And then he hit the airlock and the rest of the motherfuckers went out into space.
Yeah. Taste space, nigga.
Oh, he dominoed that nigga.
This nigga's about to taste space, my nigga.
He Marcy Cherry that nigga.
Yeah.
And then them niggas said, to be continued. We'll be back. So then, Mandalorian, he's going around the ship and he finds the cell where they're keeping Grogu.
Yeah.
And Moff Gideon's in there with the Darksaber holding it to Grogu. Mm-hmm. He gets his little, you know, evil man speech. And then they fight. And then he fucks around.
He's kind of a dick, though.
I mean, he was a bad guy.
Yeah, but he was like, yeah, you could take. I honestly thought that he was going to let him take the kid. He was like, I just don't want no mention.
Yeah, me too.
Me too. Because I thought it was kind of gonna be like Bo-Katan was gonna have a problem if he would've just let her go. It's like, yo, I need to fucking Darksaber. Why let him go?
Well, they got a different problem now, but
yeah.
So
fight was crazy though.
They get into a fight.
Yeah.
Fucks around, takes the Darksaber.
Yeah.
So this nigga has a Darksaber, that suit, and a Beskar spear.
Yeah.
Most dangerous nigga.
Unstoppable nigga.
Yeah.
So then he goes back to the cockpit. He was like, hey, got the baby. And he was like, the Dark Troopers. The fuck, not Dark Troopers. What are they?
Dark Troopers.
Yeah, so right. The Dark Troopers like, ah.
So, but before that,
boom.
Yeah. But before that, you know, Moff Gideon, like, he was like, oh, you can't just give her the saber.
Yeah.
You can't just do
that. Yeah. So Mandalorian got the Darksaber, but. It has to be won in battle, and Mando didn't know that. So now that nigga rules Mandalore.
Yeah, basically he's the ruler of Mandalore.
Yeah.
So he tried to give it to her. She was like, "I can't really take it."
And she's looking at him funny.
Yeah,
she about to try to kill him.
That's probably what's gonna happen in season 3.
Yeah, gonna do to the death.
And then you know, Dark Troopers come back on the ship. They're making their way to the cockpit. Yo,
did anybody forget about them motherfuckers? Because I forgot about them.
I forgot about them.
Me too.
I was like, wait, what's
coming? I thought they was gone.
Yeah.
And then it was like,
shit, these niggas could fly. I forgot.
Yeah. And they robots. They not real people. So yeah, the space ain't kill them. They was like, oh shit.
They made out of some ill shit. I don't know what they made out of.
I don't know what the fuck that shit is.
But titanium, nigga.
Something. But they came back on the ship. They was making their way to the cockpit. And then lo and behold, the ship just docks on to the other ship. And then this Jedi just comes swooshing everything.
Swooshing.
And then he using force powers and pushing.
And he
shit.
Fucked them niggas up. He was like,
all of them.
Yeah, I can't
and he
tell
like
you.
Crushed
I
that last nigga.
I can't tell you how many reactions I seen with grown ass men crying when they seen Luke.
Really?
You remember when we was reviewing The Last Jedi and I told you I was like, yo, I waited 20 years to see Luke Skywalker
do
not
nothing.
Swing his do nothing. Like I was upset. So to see this, I can understand why they got emotional and I felt it. But I was like, nah, I ain't gonna do that. Like
now,
this ain't the part I'm gonna cry.
Nah, it is.
Was Luke's face a deep fake or was that a real actor?
It was a deep fake.
It was.
That's why I look weird like that.
Everybody thought Everybody thought like the stand-in was Sebastian Stan,
but
which it should be.
Okay.
They should have just had him do it.
Yeah.
Because it looked too weird to me. But
yeah, it did.
Whatever.
It always does. But somebody gonna deep fake it. It's gonna look.
It's like the same thing they did with Leia in The Rise of Skywalker.
Yeah.
But they like CGI.
Yeah, and a Tarkin dude in Rogue One.
Yeah. So it's just that.
Mm.
Yeah.
Why it looks weird.
Yeah, so he's going in.
So then he gets to the cockpit. He looks at Grogu like, yo, you called me, right?
He's like, you're.
So you're right here.
Yeah, Uber's outside.
So then Grogu's hesitant to go with Luke. He was like,
I told y'all that.
Yo, go with him. That's who you call when you're on the rock. And then
he's like,
he wants Luke, permission. Luke picks him up. I guess he trusts him.
Before you go, this is what got me. This is what got me. This is what got me. Because I was watching this shit. And then, Luke was like, come, little one.
Mm-hmm.
And then fucking Mando was like, he doesn't want to go with you.
Yeah.
And he was like, he's asking for your permission. I was like,
fucking
hell. Damn.
He needs your permission to go. He's like, I want to go, daddy, but I just want.
He's scary.
Damn.
Is it okay?
Nigga took off the mask and shit.
Yeah.
It's the
second
music.
Time.
Yeah.
And then he touched his face and shit.
It's the damn music, man. It's not even the scene. It's just the music.
Telling you, Disney know how to pull at your heartstrings.
And the nigga was tearing up. You see the little tears in his eyes.
Yeah.
He's looking at his little son. He's like, oh, my son gonna go kill nigga.
Yo, I raised this nigga. Now you just gonna leave me? How the fuck you gonna leave me?
That was his mission. He had to go take the nigga.
Nah, but still, he got an attachment to him. Like, yo, I raised you. Like, I had a mission at first. First, you was a mission. Then you became my son, which is wild. But, then Luke takes him, and then they do that longing look at each other, and then, the doors close, and then...
And episode's over.
Episode over. Then we got to wait till next season. But the end credits are what got me, too. So... Yeah. They're doing a Book of Boba Fett.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
December 2021.
They trying so hard to make this nigga a badass before he actually dies.
I mean, he is.
Nah, he ain't gonna die. He ain't gonna die this time.
No, I'm talking about when he does die in what, the second Star Wars movie or first?
No. They thought he died.
After.
Yeah.
I know, but I'm just saying, y'all building him up to be like, oh, Boba's just the illest nigga, then he just dies.
Oh, no.
This takes place after he died.
Is it after he died?
Yeah,
that's why his face is fucked up. Oh, this takes place after... All this takes place after the last movie, after the Emperor gets thrown into the tube, into the lightning tube.
Yeah, the shit when he fell.
Okay. And then fucking... I mean, that's what he did.
Do it again.
And then...
Do it again, yeah.
And then before Force Awakens. Yeah. So this all takes place in between that 20-year, it's 20 years, I guess, span of time in between that last film.
Okay.
And that one. So...
I forgot what that fat nigga's name was.
Bib Fortuna.
Yeah, Bib Fortuna. There you go.
Yeah.
He don't really matter. He did.
He just shot that nigga. He didn't have a conversation.
Like, he's like, oh, he's now, like, Boba, you alive?
Aren't the Hutts like the mafia?
Yeah. So basically.
Yeah, so he's taking over.
They are, right?
Tony Soprano.
You can't hide that, man.
Jabba's Tony Soprano?
Yeah, pretty much.
Fuck with this egg plane over here.
It's Parmesan.
So I'm guessing he's going to be...
Taking over the underworld.
Yeah,
basically.
That criminal syndicate. And, it's one of those things where when remember when we was talking about when Davies auditioned for Star Wars?
Yeah.
I believe it was for The Mandalorian, that episode with Bill Burr.
Probably.
Makes sense.
But he just didn't make
the cut.
What
he would have been?
I don't know. Just somebody there.
Bill Burr's character. Or he could have been one of them Twi'leks or whatever.
Yeah,
the brother.
There.
He could have been somebody. Whatever they were called. So yeah. So basically it ends. It's Finnick and...
Darth Harlem.
Forgot about that shit. Boba Fett and Finnick.
Yep.
They go to Jabba's palace, whatever, shoot Bib Fortuna, and he just sits on the throne.
Yeah.
It's next year. more Mandalorian shit.
Yeah.
Oh, no, they said 2022, didn't they?
2021.
Oh, so it's going to be like the tail end.
But December, though, so it's not to the end of the year. Yeah. So we got to wait a whole year.
That'd be good.
I mean, it's good.
I'm with that. You know, Disney hasn't disappointed me yet.
So now, my only question, because I didn't see it anywhere, are they replacing Mandalorian and doing that, or are they doing both of those?
I think they're doing both of those, because how it ended, like, the Darksaber was unresolved,
mm-hmm.
and they got to still seize Mandalore in some way. Somebody has to be Mandalore.
Yeah. So,
I think that if they do a third season, I think that's going to happen. Like, yeah. Bo-Katan and Mando going to have to duke it out. Something's going to have to happen.
Because you can't just give her the saber and she wants to take it.
She was looking too funny.
So now, do you think people will care about the show without Baby Yoda? Even though I'm sure he's going to come back at some point.
Yeah. I mean, we've gotten used to Baby Yoda.
Yeah.
So I think they'll write it in a way where they'll ramp up the action and they'll give you more storyline and plot that you'll kind of forget. And I'm pretty sure he'll make, like, appearances here and there and shit, but you know.
And it just left the doorway open for Luke and Baby Yoda.
Because
you can't just leave this motherfucker, like, leaving. Like, you gotta know what happened to Grogu. Like, and now everybody, a lot of people was crying too. They was like, oh, so what did that mean? He died when
he murdered. Right? That's also another question, because where the fuck is he in these last Star Wars films?
I don't know. Mm. And we still don't know. Grogu got a backstory too. We don't know who took him out of the Jedi Temple.
Yep.
We don't know
who saved him from Order 66.
Yeah, so it's mad shit. It's mad shit they could do with this right now.
Yeah.
The funny shit about Disney Plus, right? So, I got a new debit card, right? So, obviously, when you get a new debit card, you got to change all your shit where it's like, you got to, you know, they take the money out automatically.
Mm-hmm.
So I forgot to do Disney Plus, right?
Yeah.
So, I went to go watch Mandalorian, didn't go through. You know how, like, when you check your email, they're like, oh, there seems to be a problem with your account.
Yeah.
And, you know, you got to change your information. Disney Plus aggressive ass. Yo, your subscription canceled, my nigga.
Like, dogs. Yeah. You want our money.
I don't know what's going on with your account, B, but
we getting our money.
Holler at us when you fix that. I was like, all right, shit. Punch my shit in real quick. All right.
It's like,
watch the Mandalorian.
Stewie and Brian, where's my money at?
Where's my money?
Where's my money?
Let's see. So Mandalorian's over with till God knows when.
But shout out to John Favreau and Dave Filoni, because they're single-handedly saving this shit.
Doing an excellent job.
If they are not part of the next trilogy's movie, they like made a mistake. I swear to God. Like, because if you had told me like the Mandalorian would have turned out this good, and been doing this much like stuff for actual Star Wars lore and character stuff, I wouldn't know. I wouldn't believe you.
Right.
Mm. Like, they gotta be part of the next trilogy. If not, it's fucking waste. It's waste.
Yeah. I was always up here and remember, it's a lot of shit I said up here. It's like when I said like the movies don't work because they don't really give the lore or nothing like that. It just speed past everything. Mm-hmm. Like, you actually need a series to like build this shit up.
Well, we got a couple of them now. We got like 10 of them now, nigga.
Disney comes in. So we got the whole MCU shit. We got the Star Wars shit. They announced what Disney announced. 50 something new shows. So
you're
gonna get backstory out the ass. What? So that's whenever that comes. So they got to what, like 2023 of new shit?
Something like that. 2025?
I think it's gonna be working.
See?
Like 5 years, I think. Five years worth of shit.
If the earth don't blow up by then, we should be good.
The panoramic don't take us up?
Yeah, then we can go back outside. Yeah, the Panda Express.
The Panda Express. The name of the episode, Panda Express?
No. I hope not.
Panda.
Yeah.
Let's see. Topic time. So, Coming to America first look. So we saw a couple pictures of Coming to America. Why is Wesley Snipes a fucking like a bounty hunter, and why is Tiana Taylor his like girl?
What happened?
Is that
you don't like that?
I'm trying to understand what the fuck Wesley Snipes is though.
Barry. I don't know.
He's Blade, nigga.
Blade.
Can be fucking Blade bounty
a safari hunter. So everyone obviously aged a lot.
They don't look it though, like
don't look it.
No,
Eddie Murphy look old as shit compared to.
His face is just fat.
He don't look that bad though. Like,
I didn't say he look bad. It's just like a
well, no shit. It's wide been 25 years. Nigga, which one?
I told y'all to take so long.
All right, that's fair. I got nothing for that one.
But how's it look to y'all?
I didn't think it was that bad. I was like, okay, this looks cool.
Now I'm gonna watch it. I just didn't know that Wesley Snipes was in this.
You ain't know that?
Nah.
Yeah, me neither.
No, I knew that.
Is Kevin Hart supposed to be in this? Or that was
No.
As far as I'm aware, no. Please. Unless he shows up in like some weird cameo or something.
Please no. Please no.
That niggas hate Kevin Hart, yeah.
Nah, it's just like, no.
He's in everything. What the fuck else does he need to be in?
Call success, nigga. Get some.
Did you
see the special?
Did you see his last special?
No.
Don't.
No. All right, cool.
That's the internet.
I think Yeah, no.
Oh yeah, I got Netflix now. I can watch it. I'm about to watch it.
No.
Yeah, well, I just want to see how bad it is.
You want to see how bad it is?
Yeah, I want to see for myself.
Waste more of your time.
Yep.
Waste more.
The fuck else I'm going to do, nigga?
I don't know. Watch something that's worth your time.
These are all the thoughts when I watch them.
What?
Why?
Like, why am I watching?
Why am I wasting my time?
I mean,
I don't find them funny
anymore, or just at all.
I mean, yeah, I never found him funny.
No shit. Yeah. I mean, he was funny at a point, but it's just like I'm tired of seeing him, and his jokes is just not up to par anymore. So I don't know. Rise of Skywalker's Naomi. What?
Aki.
Yep. Cast as Whitney Houston. What?
My bad.
Biopic.
Yeah.
My bad. Get the fuck out. Nah.
Well, she don't look like Whitney. That's the only thing. She don't look at like her at all.
Yeah. Naomi.
It's the only other black person in the whole movie that wasn't Finn.
Oh, okay.
The black chick that he met in the last movie that he's supposed to fall in love with, apparently, just because she's black and he black.
Who's playing Bobby?
I don't know.
I don't think they got that.
And has Bobby Brown signed off on this? Because if they don't include the Bobby story, this shit is a waste.
It probably won't.
We gotta see all the drug uses. We gotta see when she first tried it to the bathtub.
Damn.
That whole thing.
Damn.
No bathtub, nigga.
Damn.
Like we don't know how she got the fuck out of here.
Surfboard. My bad. I went a little too far.
Nah. Fuck it, we lied. They already seen it. Nah, but a Whitney Houston biopic, didn't they do that trash ass one on Lifetime?
Wait, that was good. You talking about the Bobby story, right?
No, they did.
They did a
Houston one. They did a Leah one. They did Lifetime do all the whack ass biopics first, and then it's like, we need to redeem ourselves, so we need to actually have people sign off on this, and we're gonna do a real tribute to Whitney.
I mean, I'm sure the actress is fine. She just don't look like Whitney Houston to me, so that's my biggest whatever.
Mm.
But you know, Whitney deserves a movie, so I'm not mad at it. Like,
yeah,
it is what it is.
As
long as there's no prosthetic noses or nothing.
Like
Zoe Saldana.
Yeah, that Zoe Saldana shit.
Is that movie out? I think that movie is out.
Which one? The Zoe Saldana when she played
Nina Simone?
Yeah, that shit been out.
I've never seen it.
Good. You don't need to. Pete Davidson is removing every one of his tattoos.
Yes.
Is this for movie roles?
Yes.
Basically.
Okay.
Because I think he said it takes like 3 hours and the makeup to cover up all his tattoos and shit. So.
That's fucked.
That's just going to hurt.
Yeah.
I mean, price you pay, nigga.
I guess.
It hurt to get him. It's going to hurt to get rid of him.
I wonder if Chris did that. But Chris don't really show his arms.
He only got...
Yeah,
and they're small, but they're small. The one Pete's got like full arm sleeves and all kind of crazy. You know,
yeah, Chris was a slave, so you know he had to cover up his tattoos and shit. He probably had like a naked scene or something like that.
Yeah, he was also a gangster in Queen of the South. You had to go to the slave
room. Yeah.
I'm just thinking where you would show your arms.
He's in Walking Dead shooting zombies.
He had a little look back, but yeah.
You get the little ass part in that movie.
Don't say that.
Damn, don't say his little ass part.
That's what Bobby said, because he's going to come at me for that.
That's what Bobby said.
Yo, Chris, we love you.
My bad.
I'll just repeat what Bobby said.
I don't know. I ain't mean to say that.
Oh, like, you said it from deep.
I meant it, but I ain't mean it. It was off the cuff, man. He was coming at me. So I was like,
I meant to
take that.
I meant to insult him, but I ain't mean it.
Nah.
Fuck you and your little show.
Nah, look, Chris cool.
Nah, he is cool, though.
Yeah.
Jim Henson's Dinosaurs gets a Disney Plus debut date.
Knocking them out.
Why is this shit coming back?
It's not coming. Well, it's just, no, they're just putting it on Disney Plus.
Oh.
Yeah. January.
Hey, they need to come back.
Not the mama. 29th? Yeah, the 29th of January is coming back.
Didn't this shit have like 4 seasons?
4. And then I think it ended with the fucking meteor coming, right?
it actually ended?
Yeah.
And take it off the air?
No, I feel like they all died at the end. Yeah.
Damn.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if it's the meteor, but I feel like they all died at the end. It's been so long since
sounds
I watched it.
Right.
But yeah.
Okay.
4 seasons, I think there was.
Watch that show.
Yeah, I'm going to watch it. It's on Disney Plus. What the fuck?
The animatronics was good as hell.
Hell yeah.
Not the mama.
Especially for the 90s.
Yeah, I know.
They get hit and pops, his eyes blinking and shit.
Where we at? Netflix announces live action series Yu Yu Hakusho. No, come on, man. Why are we doing a live Yu Yu Hakusho?
You want to see Kuba with the
no,
whatever
it is.
Especially with Netflix, because Netflix has not done a good adaptation of an anime yet. I think Death Note was the worst one.
Y'all like Bleach, right?
No,
it was okay.
Yeah, it was bearable.
Yeah, it was satisfactory.
I'm trying to see, is this going to be whitewashed?
Probably.
Or are they taking it from an anime studio and then just throwing it like Bleach? I heard Bleach was actually good.
It was cool.
It wasn't bad.
Full Metal bad.
Yeah, the
Full Metal Death Note bad.
Yeah, the Full Metal wigs was fucking crazy.
Death Note really wasn't that bad. It was just that they whitewashed those.
I refuse to watch it.
No,
Willem Dafoe?
Death Note was
as
horrible.
Ryuk? I mean, you playing.
I'm not watching it.
Not playing.
I refuse.
That shit looks scary as shit.
I refuse.
I don't want to cut anyone off.
What's up?
Let me exit.
Okay, go ahead.
I don't want to ruin.
No, you go.
No, you guys are great.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lenny.
Thank you for... You know, this anxiety ridden.
I'm sorry to put you on the spot like that.
You said you want to do your own, so I get used to it, right?
I know, yeah. And this was a wake up call.
Second guessing it.
Skitter off the whole shit. She said, I ain't fucking with this.
Like, nah, I ain't doing it.
All right.
But, the fuck is Yu Yu Hakusho.
Yeah.
I don't want this.
No,
is it an animated series?
No, it's live action.
It's a live action series.
He's gonna go spirit like, gun. He's gonna fuck out.
That spirit gun gonna look fucking so bootleg, nigga.
It's gonna be like the Kamehameha in Dragon Ball Evolution.
That's just gonna be horrible.
Don't bring that up again.
Hey yo, I still want to know when the Juggernaut origin story gonna be.
He been told that shit.
Yeah, he told that already.
I don't know what episode it was, but he
that was Kurt in the chat.
Oh yeah, I told that.
Yeah,
I don't know where it's at.
Yeah, it's one. I don't know, nigga. This is 121.
Yeah,
so you gonna have to go figure that out, nigga. Maybe one of them niggas in the chat know.
Yeah, I know, right.
That was episode 72. No,
I sit here, I say words, and as soon as we're done, I forget every single thing I ever said on this show ever.
Yeah,
like ever. So every time y'all remind me, it's a surprise.
That shit is amazing.
Yeah.
I'd
be like, yeah, what y'all want in the episode? I don't know what I said.
Dog, it'd be gone. Yeah. Like, I mean, gone, nigga. Yeah. So I'd be like, I don't know.
But y'all want a UU live action series? That's a no.
Okay. I don't know. So it depends.
On?
I feel like UU Hakusho can be done, I think, maybe pretty well, considering the way the show was.
Nigga, you don't believe that.
I am trying to convince myself. But it's like, because it's just a dude who shoots spirit guns and a nigga with a sword and nigga with a rose whip. Go. And they fighting like human like niggas, really. I guess not. They fight, I mean, demons and some of them do.
I feel like Netflix is grasping at straws right now because of that anime boom that they had. What is year that they had with anime? I feel like they just kind of throw shit out of walls, see what sticks.
Also, Yu Hakusho was insanely popular
in the 90s.
No. Period. 80s? Just period, nigga.
No, I mean,
niggas love Yu Yu Hakusho. What the fuck?
But
if you ask anybody about Yu, if they niggas fuck with Yu Yu Hakusho,
I know they fuck with Yu Yu Hakusho, but it's like
fucking Yusuke Urameji, my nigga. The fuck?
Kurobara. The Lion King 2 director Barry Jenkins was blown away by the movie script.
Yes,
they bullshitting. They trying to sell us on it. I'm not watching it. Nope.
You think they lying?
Yep.
You gonna lie about the lions?
No matter how good the script is, they don't stop the bullshit CGI with the lines and, you know, the fucked up scar and just everything. Well,
Scar dead now, so you don't gotta worry about that.
Well, I think it's a prequel.
Oh, is it a prequel?
I'm just guessing.
I don't know what it, I just know that.
Yeah, I'm not watching.
That's the only thing that I don't think it will work.
Yeah, the only thing I know is, like, he said he read it, like, he was skeptical about doing a sequel, and then he read the script, and he's like, the script is so amazing, he's like, all right, fam, I'll do it.
Yeah.
I don't know what that means. I don't know if it's a prequel, sequel, trequel. I don't know what it is.
Trequel.
I don't know.
That's the name of the podcast.
Damn
it, man.
Yeah, I'm not with it.
Stop copyright shit.
That's a lot of money that we don't have.
Damn. Facts.
The Walking Dead comedy spinoff in the works.
This is some shit
I don't want.
This is some dumb shit.
I had to make sure I read that right.
No, that's correct.
The Walking Dead comedy spinoff.
Shaun of the Dead.
What's
what the fuck we need this for?
Well, yeah, what's funny about... Okay, so who's gonna be in it?
No idea.
Because they killed a lot of people.
I mean, I figure you just get new, just center around new people.
My nigga, they've been in Atlanta for like 10 years. You telling me they just not gonna find new people just out of nowhere? Like, oh, well, y'all been hiding.
I mean, there's other human beings in the whole entirety of the world that are suffering through a zombie apocalypse. So yes, I think they can just take it somewhere else.
What if we find out that all this shit is like Corona?
Could be. This is just one of them things like Walking Dead was super popular and the show was ending and they grasping the straws to try to keep that money coming in, but they need to just maybe not do this one.
Yeah, I'm not feeling this.
Yeah, don't. But, and then maybe I'll watch it. It might be good, but.
Might.
I'm not excited about that.
Let's see. Deaf community protests hearing actor casted as deaf character in The Stand. So. The deaf community protests.
I just want to see who's going to do it first.
Mm-hmm. Hearing actors casted as deaf character in The Stand. Mm-hmm. Who would they talk to about this?
What you mean?
What juice would they throw?
It was you. I was waiting to see who's going to do it first.
Okay, so what is the
see?
Issue?
Anybody see this shit? Nobody gonna see it.
Yeah. Members of the deaf community are protesting a hearing actor playing a deaf character in the upcoming CBS All Access series, The Stand. According to the Hollywood Reporter, actors Antoinette Abamonte, James Caverly, a bunch of other motherfuckers, are among 70 signatories that have released it. Man, fuck these people.
Why are you mad at them for being mad? That don't make sense to me. There's like, hey,
representation.
I mean, you couldn't find a deaf actor. Like, I'm sure that exists somewhere. Like, yeah. Why didn't you just get a deaf actor to play a deaf person? Like, I can't be mad at them for that.
They had a deaf actor in what's the DC show we watched? The DC show we watched was Slade in it.
Titans.
So you do have deaf actors out there, but
yeah, see, they exist. So you know what I mean?
Oh, he was really deaf.
Yeah,
but yeah, I think so.
And trans.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's up.
Right. Even though the trans thing isn't brought up on the show.
Yeah.
That's just not. The actor themselves just happens to be.
Oh yeah, you're right. Yeah.
I don't think it was mentioned on the show.
I didn't think he was really deaf.
Yeah, I believe
that didn't come up.
I mean, it's part of the character. I mean, it was part of the character.
I think the trans thing was more of a story than him actually being deaf. Because once we found out, we was like, oh shit, I didn't even know that.
Yeah, I didn't know he was actually deaf in real life, though.
Yeah, I believe so. Don't quote me, but I feel like he is.
Okay.
So yeah, just got that nigga in and problem solved.
Okay, let him be mad. Cool.
I don't know.
You say that until they make a white person play a black person. then your tone gonna definitely change.
I mean, then I'll protest. I'll write some angry on Twitter.
Okay.
See, Tom Cruise ran on Mission Impossible set.
Flavors.
Where are you going about now? Scientology?
You didn't hear it?
Nah.
Yeah. Oh, no, you should have listened to that.
I thought it was like the nigga in fucking Tropic Thunder. He was like, scorched fucking Earth, motherfucker.
So, I mean, you're about to pull it up, but basically it was because they're filming Mission Impossible 7 right now, and he caught some people not following COVID protocol.
Yeah.
And he snapped off on him because it's like, yo, we're not getting this movie that's shut down as people are losing their homes because they can't come to work. Like they're looking to us to do this right. So you got to do this shit right. So like, I don't agree.
It's in a tweet.
Yeah. I don't agree with necessarily maybe like doing it the way that he did it, but I agree with what he was saying.
Because,
you know, you don't want your boss yelling at you in front of everybody like that.
It's like
making
Tropic Thunder.
Yeah.
Because they believe in us and what we're doing. I'm on the phone with every studio at night. Insurance companies. Producers. And they're looking at us and using us to make their movies. We are creating thousands of jobs, you
motherfuckers.
I don't ever want to see it again.
Ever again.
Ever. And if you don't do it, you're fired. And if I see you do it again, you're gone.
You're fucking gone, buddy.
Gone.
That's it. And you too. And you too.
You can call some of your job.
And you. Don't you ever do it again. That's it. No apologies.
No apologies.
You tell us to the people that
you're fucking gone. You're out of here, buddy.
Because our industry is shut down. It's not going to put food on their table or pay for their college education. That's what I sleep with every night.
Man, you're the dick, Tom Cruise. Yelling at me, man. I don't give a fuck if you're Tom Cruise or not.
No, he's not wrong.
He's not wrong, but don't yell at me like I'm a fucking child.
That's where he's wrong.
So I'm sorry. I'm beyond your apologies. I have told you, and now I want. And if you don't do it, you're effed.
You're effed?
Effed or out, I think.
You're not shutting this movie down! Is it understood? If I see it again, you're f***ing gone. And so are you. So you're going to cost him his job. And I see it on the set, you're gone. And you're gone. That's it.
That's it.
Am I clear? Do you understand what I want? Do you understand the responsibility that you have? Because I will deal with your reason.
And if you can't be reasonable, and I can't deal with your logic, you're fired.
Fired.
That's it. That is it.
Who else Tom Cruise think he is?
Tom Cruise. Yeah, it is.
I trust you guys to be here.
Like, so...
Cue that Ludacris song. Right? Back, motherfucker, you don't know me like
so he's
that.
Not wrong in what he's saying. Everything that he's saying is correct, minus, but he shouldn't be screaming at them like that and like talking to them like they're little kids.
Yeah, my nigga, I'm not your child. Yeah. I work on a set. You didn't see me. If it was like he saw this same guy multiple times without a
That's
mask.
What it was.
Well, we don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I think it happened
if
before.
If it was that, you reprimand him. You don't go on no screaming rampage, yelling at the whole staff, talking about if I catch him without a mask, you're fired too, and you, and don't single me out like, you know, I'm just.
But I feel like the way that he's saying it is like, I think he did try to talk to them.
Yeah.
It happened again, and now he's like, look, I'm on, and he's saying like, I'm on the phone with all these people, like, you're doing all this, yada, yada. Like, to the point, like, he burnt out like $500,000, like, boat, yeah, or whatever, so all the cats and crew could go somewhere so they can quarantine, so they could make this film. So, like,
yeah.
He's trying to make this work, and he's like, yo, if you do this and we get shut down because you don't want to listen, so I understand his frustration, but this is not the way to go. Yeah, no. I don't agree with the yelling. I agree with what he was saying, not how he was saying it. What he was saying was accurate, like, hey, look.
Yeah, it's
other people's, like, this whole industry's fucked up. If we get shut down, people can't get money. They can't get money. They can't pay their mortgage. They don't have houses. They can't put food on their table. Like, and I don't want to jeopardize all that because you can't listen.
Yeah.
Right.
So.
I don't know, but don't yell at me, dog.
Nah, for real, because I would have wanted to fight the nigga.
Ain't Tom Cruise like 5'7"?
Something. Nah,
hit a nigga
in
the face
in
an apple box, nigga.
And a nigga like 60-something?
Yeah. And be cruising to see Jesus, nigga. Boom.
Punch in your heart, old nigga.
I don't know. Tom Cruise might be in shape. He might work.
Yeah, he might. Yeah, yeah.
And he do all his own stunts. He might actually know some Krav Maga, some shit, nigga.
Didn't this nigga blow his knees out doing this stuff?
I wouldn't be surprised.
I don't know, nigga. Yeah. He ain't Vince McMahon.
Movie theaters considering slashing prices of Warner Brothers movies with HBO Max releases.
Yeah, they being dicks.
Them niggas is salty.
Yeah.
Now, they slashing prices to try to get people to come into theaters or just a slight to Warner Brothers?
It's a slight.
Both.
They're considering it.
It's both of those things.
Yeah.
It's the, hey, I gotta find a way. I gotta find a way to get people to come to the theater if it's on HBO Max and the theaters at the same time. Why the fuck would you go to the theaters?
Right.
Oh, it's $3? Maybe I'll go to the theaters.
Yeah.
And also, it's, hey, fuck you. We're charging $3 and you're only getting a penny off of this shit. Like, that's the other thing. That's the other thing. They're slashing the prices and they're not trying to pay them out. Because the reason why concessions are so expensive for movie theaters is because that's where they really make their money from.
Yeah.
Box office, they don't make as much money off of box office sales as people think they do.
Mm.
Like, so those prices or whatever, a majority of that movie goes to the theater companies and all that stuff. Like, yeah. So they're like, eat a dick, we're going to make $3 and you're not getting shit from this.
Right.
So they're trying to find a way to, convince people to come to movie theaters.
Is this the right move, though? I don't think it is.
I don't...
Because you remember that they said that studio companies can own movie theaters now. So do you want to wait it out and then be bankrupt and then these motherfuckers end up owning your shit?
I don't know. I'd rather have my staff not dying.
Yeah, it's kind of a damned if you do, damned if you don't type of situation, because it's like they have to try to do something, because obviously most people, especially in this COVID times, aren't going to go to the movie theaters if the movie is playing on HBO Max at the same time. I'm just watching HBO Max.
I'm not leaving my house, though.
Okay, so then how do I convince people to come see the movie in the theater so that I can still make money to pay my employees? So I have to figure something out. This is a way to do it. If I can sell the tickets for $3 to $5 and still maybe make a profit for us, that might make sense for them to do. Yeah, it might be, in the long run, more harmful than it is good, because now they're kind of sticking their thumb in the eye of Warner Brothers, and maybe when shit gets more regular, I might end up fucking them over later. But the fuck you gotta do? Our niggas gotta eat right now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's damned if you do, damned if you don't.
All right. HBO Max will also remove Chappelle's Show at Dave Chappelle's request. Slapping a dick on the table. Look, Dave Chappelle said, look, I'm not getting paid for this shit. I don't want this shit on no platform. So first it was Netflix. Netflix obliged.
Uh-huh.
HBO Max was like, nah, we're gonna keep it up there. I want to know what the conversation was and what happened.
But did they, what?
Huh?
To what?
To why HBO all of a sudden just got with the program and just took the shit off.
Well, I guess business with Dave Chappelle equals money because they can see it with Netflix. So if he, this is just a long shot, if he gets a hand on the Chappelle show, then he can put it on both streaming platforms. That way he wins.
Yeah.
That or they're banking on some unknown future project that maybe if we do this, he'll be more amenable to work with us in the future.
Yeah.
And that way everybody can sort of win.
Yeah, but everybody putting their comedy specials on Netflix now.
Yeah.
When the last time you seen an HBO comedy special?
I mean, Rami's was up there like earlier this year. And I think Lil Rel put one up. I think that was this year. But
it's not promoted, though.
This year has been
not
weird.
Promoted well at all.
Yeah, they're not. It's not promoted as much as like maybe the Netflix stuff is. But I don't think their goal is comedy specials the same way Netflix does.
Yeah.
But I mean, it doesn't have to be a comedy special. It could be anything. He could do another Chappelle show version. He can do a movie. There's other things he could do that maybe might make sense for like HBO Max or something.
Mm.
So then if they have a better standing relationship, it might make it easier going forward to, you know, entice him to do something with them. Good on them.
Yeah, I'm convinced that Senior Sweat, they sell drugs or something.
Why?
Because he be giving us subscriptions, like subs on Twitch.
No, he's just a real nigga.
Nah, real nigga, but he sell drugs. Shout out to you. Where the fuck you get all this money from, though?
I mean, he worked. That's the other thing. That nigga worked all the goddamn time. And like, because he's like a supervisor or like managerial position at his job. So when niggas don't come to work, sometimes he get stuck at work.
Oh, yeah.
That's why. So if he worked a whole shift, he might get stuck and fuck around, have to work another whole half shift or work a whole another shift because there's nobody to cover. Because somebody got to watch some badass kids. So he be making money.
That nigga moving drugs through them kids.
I believe it. Yeah. Them niggas is troubled children anyway, so they probably
good. I know, right? They probably with it.
They probably good at something. No, I mean,
Swift, they the drug lord.
That's why it's Spanish, because he got that
I know,
hyena.
Right?
Yeah.
Got to keep his identity hidden. Yeah. Senior Sweat, that's a nigga.
Yeah.
But shout out to you, man. Appreciate you.
Facts.
Let's see. Gaming news. The Game Awards 2020. The Game Awards 2020 set record.
Wait, hold on.
What?
This one you skipped.
Oh, the one I added on there? Oh, yeah. Pokemon Sword and Shield fan accidentally names nephew after Gen 8 Pokemon.
I'm sorry, what?
So, I guess...
I just seen it. I was like, how the fuck this
guy? So this guy was in a car with his sister, and they were getting ready to... she was on the way to the hospital. And they were thinking of names for the child, and he was in the backseat playing a game, and he had just caught Zacian. The wolf, the dog.
Yeah.
So he yells that out. And everybody's like,
oh, that's good.
That sounds like a good name. He was like, what?
He's like, wait, no, that's a Pokemon.
No. And I just thought that shit was funny. Now the question I wanted to ask, like, if you could name your child after some fictional shit, what would you name him?
Oh, shit. Damn.
I don't know my girl watching right now, but let us have four boys. You already know what's going on.
Leonardo,
Michelangelo, Raphael, Donatello.
You already know what's going on. Off rip.
I don't know. So like, the stuff I can think, like, Naruto is not a good name for a human being.
Sasuke.
Sasuke is not a good name for a human being.
Sasuke. Yes, it is. It could be.
Sasuke
it's
Jackson.
Your child.
Sasuke Jackson.
Sasuke Jackson is lit. Sasuke Jones.
Nah, yeah.
Shit, like, one of my boys, he named his kid Pharaoh.
Pharaoh?
Okay. Yeah.
That's not bad. That's cool.
That's dope.
That's good.
But he not like, I would like.
He not Egyptian that shit?
No, he not Egyptian at nothing, but he's not famous. Like, normally famous people do that wild shit where they name their child like some off brand shit, like Gene. like
Apple.
Yeah, like Apple or some shit. Diesel.
Vin.
Yeah. Oh, Mark.
I mean, see, Yosuke. Like,
Yosuke.
This is like Urameshi.
Yeah.
Yosuke.
Luffy.
Teacher's gonna be confused.
Sanji,
right? When a fucking black kid raised their hand.
Asian in here?
Nope. Nami's not bad. Nami's a good girl. That's not too bad. Robin is cool.
Ahsoka.
Ahsoka.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Suki.
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 Oh, shit. Remy.
Dalinar.
Remy.
Dalinar.
What the fuck is that for?
Book.
Oh.
Tyrion.
Oh, Adelon. Adelon isn't
Tyrion,
Tyrion.
Tyrion Lannister.
Chewbacca.
No, hell no.
Yo, Daenerys.
Chewbacca Jones,
Daenerys
come back here.
Is not a bad name.
It's Daenerys
not.
Isn't a bad name. It's just fucking wild.
There's gonna be a lot of Daenerys.
There's gonna be a lot of Daenerys in like people, the next 5-10 years.
You think? Maybe you think it fell off because the show ended so badly?
Nah, people like that. I think that's one of those
the height
shows
of it?
That,
yeah.
I think that's one of those shows that like never go. Do I want to put it with The Office? I don't think I want to put it with The Office. No,
because it ended so bad.
Yeah.
It ended so bad.
Yeah. But it's one of those shows that like live on in infamy, like, you know, The Office, Game of Thrones, you know, shit like that. Hmm. Yeah, I don't know what else besides them.
Samurai Pizza Cat?
All right. So Game of the Wars 2020 set viewership number. What? I can't read.
Well, you
the Game of Wars.
Take a look in a book. Read it, Rainbow.
So the Game of Wars 2020 set record viewership number with over 83 million live streams.
Yeah,
is this shit ever going to a fucking venue again?
It shouldn't.
Yeah, I'm sure it will.
If we could get 83 million motherfuckers to watch this shit from the comfort of their home and be safe, and we don't got to, so they don't got to do, you know, the expensive things with like props and all that shit. All we need is like a stage, camera, backdrop, play the shit on the screen. We save mad money, and we get, and they still got 83 million motherfuckers.
Yeah, one mic, yeah, one man,
by myself. You right, man?
Yeah.
But
you right, man?
Didn't they always stream the Game Awards though? Even though they was doing it, they like filmed it. I know. I think like the first original was, I think it used to come on Spike. Uh-huh. But then after that, I feel like they streamed them anyway. So it's like
I wonder what the budget was.
That's the only thing. I think the budgets were obviously different because they don't got to get a venue and all that kind of shit.
Yeah, shit was $150.
Probably, at least
niggas like, spend that much. Like
500. Nigga bought a green screen and some
got
vans.
You got a couple graphics to put up and shit.
Yeah.
You know, that shit didn't cost that much. Usually to put on this whole ordeal, you got to fly people in. You got to pay for like sponsorships and all this shit. This shit probably, it's probably like a fourth of what they usually spend.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure it was probably all profit this year compared to maybe other years. So
Yo, what if BlurCon was done online?
If BlurCon was done online,
I don't think that'll work the same.
That, nah, it probably would.
Nah, just cons won't work online.
Yeah, just because the people is like what makes it a big thing.
Yeah,
like just being around all the people and seeing all the stuff. Yeah. Like you could put the panels online, obviously.
Yeah,
but I think it's more than just the panels. I think it's the whole experience as a whole.
Yeah, I think we're tired of Zoom calls at this point, though. I think we need the world to open back up so we can get some human interaction.
Well, you
somewhere,
better start
somehow.
Taking some vaccines then, nigga.
Nope. I'm not taking that shit, man.
Well,
but
then I don't know the fuck to tell you, nigga. Either you vaccinate up or we gonna stay in the house.
Vaccinate up.
Guess I'm in the crib then.
But fucking hit, you better get that spoon and heat up the needle.
But the thing with the thing with what?
What the fuck he talking about?
The thing with the vaccine, you can still get it. It's just that your body will fight it off.
What if Haran is the cure to fucking COVID? Oh,
no.
Yeah, I be thinking that shit all the time. Like, what if like some simple shit can cure like some other shit?
Yeah, it could.
Cause I ain't never seen a crack a sick heroin addict, nigga. Not sick off of fucking other shit.
Sick heroin addict.
Yeah, they just be sick off that shit.
My thing is, like,
I need a fix, mate.
They found this cure for COVID so quick,
yeah.
In a year because the economy was dying.
Man.
But when people was dying of AIDS and it didn't affect the economy, we still ain't got a cure for that shit.
Man.
I think it has to affect the economy for us to actually give a fuck and find a cure.
Yep.
So
there's a cure for AIDS. I mean, not AIDS, HIV.
HIV. I'm talking about. We're not talking about Dr. Sebi. We're not talking about no shit like that,
so,
right?
Cure or treatment.
I believe there is a cure for HIV, but I believe it's not like something that could be like readily viable just to use everyday use type of shit. I think it's like a last ditch like effort type of thing.
Mm.
Where I think it was a very oddly specific type of thing that happened to work for like.
He has two white blood cells left.
Yeah,
stick them.
It's not like a thing. Like, oh, I got HIV.
Stick them.
You're not getting HIV on Monday and then be cured by Thursday. Like, it's not like one of them things yet.
I can't risk it.
You know, that's a good point. I don't know why there is. I don't know. There's got to be some type of reason what makes that different. I don't know what it's it
last
is.
Last thing to cure polio.
Yeah.
Niggas ain't cure Lyme's, rickets, no shit like that.
Can you cure Lyme's?
I
don't know what it
is. It's a cure for everything. We just haven't found it yet.
But, ecstasy.
What?
Oh. Damn. Are you okay? What's your life about? I know you had a rough week. Are you okay?
Why?
I'm just making sure, man.
Why?
I don't know what your life about. I got to ask questions sometimes. We'll talk about here.
Does a nigga say ecstasy? What's wrong with ecstasy?
You just named like three drugs. First
it
was heroin.
Haran and ecstasy. That's two.
Okay.
I'm just saying, that's not three. When I get to drug number three, which I'll get to eventually.
You be talking about mushrooms for like at least 30 episodes.
Because I've been trying to get them for at least 30 episodes and this nigga don't want to help
drug use on Twitch. Boom. So Among Us is on Switch and is cross-platform with mobile and PC users.
That's
fucking
crack.
Lit.
That's
I think next year, top of the year, is coming to Xbox. I don't know about you PlayStation motherfuckers, but sorry for you. But yeah, we back on as soon as that new map drop. Yeah. So that's supposed to drop some. That should drop the same time it drops on Xbox. So
is it?
I don't know. I'm just guessing. It makes sense to me.
Yeah. I know they said soon. I just don't remember what the date was.
They said like January. Yeah, okay. Something like that.
Nintendo Switch makes the perfect sense.
It does.
Yeah, mad sense. And I was playing it too. Smooth.
No dropouts.
Butter.
You can use that instead of your phone now?
Yeah. Because I'm a broke boy and I have a PC.
Broke boy.
It's not for Mac, though. Oh, okay. You got to be, you know. I don't know why they didn't make the shit for
Macs. Macs is more expensive than PCs,
like,
nigga.
They made it, huh?
Macs is more expensive than PCs.
Yo, chill, relax.
They're talking about being a broke boy.
I'm a champ and a broke boy. Say some bitch.
Let me get a new job so I can fucking afford to come in here. Whip that ass. Yeah.
EA is buying Codemasters for $1.2 billion. God
billion dollars.
Yeah.
For $1.2 billion to take lead in racing game market.
Yeah.
They're doing this exclusively for racing games?
Yeah, but I think the bigger thing that made that more of a news thing was that that's I believe the same company that
Take-Two
was going to purchase. Yeah. And so basically they just overbid them.
That's fucked up.
And they have more money than Take-Two does, so Take-Two might not be able to make a counteroffer.
Damn.
So basically they just scooped this shit from underneath them niggas.
Damn.
And I think that's why that was more of a news story.
Give me loot.
Basically. Give me that shit. What gaming company?
Yeah.
They just took that shit.
Okay. Mass Effect original developers are flocking back to BioWare.
Oh, what's happening?
We out here.
It's happening.
Gang.
We out here.
Gang. Man. Biotics in this bitch.
Yeah, we definitely talked about that shit when we was talking about what, Andromeda? And yeah. I was telling Hesh, I was like, all the original people left.
Yeah. Well, they back now, nigga.
Yeah.
Do you have high hopes?
Yeah.
There's
original people.
No.
You said no?
What? For real?
I refuse to get my hopes up high.
Oh, you don't want to do that?
No. Because I would be very, very sad if it's not well.
That was another funny thing with the whole Star Wars thing. Like, I was watching Mad Reactions. Yeah. When the niggas seen that X-Wing, one of these motherfuckers, Star Wars theory, he was like, don't give me hope. This nigga seen Luke, he started bawling. Yeah. Like, this nigga.
Niggas love Star
Wars. But he explained it, though. He was like, you know, he was watching shit since he was like a kid, like six.
Mm-hmm.
I understand.
Yeah.
I watched that shit when I was like 97.
I guess I get it.
Yeah, so don't give me hope because I want it to be good. Because I tried to play, and I think I'm gonna try again one day to like actually play through Andromeda and just finish it and beat it, just so I can say that I did it.
Mm.
But I could not get through. It was rough for me.
Let's see. Cyberpunk 2077 removed from PlayStation Store. Sony offers refunds.
Womp, womp.
This game.
Well, that's why they took it off, so you don't have to give out refunds.
Is nuts, my nigga. So I play on Xbox, and I've had a couple of bug encounters. I did a mission. I was driving in the car, and I went pause to go to the kitchen to get something. Came back. This nigga was stuck at a red light for 5 minutes. My dumb ass sitting there looking at it. I think it's part of the story. I'm thinking like, all right, light gonna turn. Some action about to hit the corner. Something gonna happen. I'm sitting there legit 5 minutes. Nothing's happening. Like, yo, did this shit freeze? And then I load the checkpoint back up. I'm still there. I'm like, dog, I don't know how to get out this shit.
You can't go back?
Luckily they got some autosave shit where they save it like 20 times within like,
pretty regularly.
Yeah, so I had to go back maybe to like two scenes ago where I shot somebody. I had to do that shit again, get back in the car, and I was like, all right, we cool now, but I don't think that shit should have happened. Or maybe my dumb ass just paused at the wrong spot. I don't know.
I mean, it shouldn't and have then, happened like that. No.
My car started flipping.
Yeah.
Like I tried to take somebody out a car, got in the car barrel rolled, and then drove off. That shit barrel rolled and then sped the fuck off. I was like, I thought I was wild. I was like, maybe I just need sleep. I'm just turn this shit off.
Is it me?
Yeah. I thought I was wilding. I was like, you know what? It was like 11, 12 o'clock. I was like, you know what? Can't do this. I'm going to sleep.
Yeah, no, it's buggy. But this is why I hate that. That's your experience, because I've encountered bugs. I don't think I've encountered some stuff, and I think I got to a point was further along in the game where I was like sort of ensnared by it.
Yeah,
like there's a good game in there.
Yeah,
it just sucks that all this bug stuff is happening, because I know, like, if you have a PlayStation, it's probably damn near, from what I heard, it's damn near unplayable. I'm playing on Xbox, and I've encountered some bugs, but I have not encountered. Yeah. To the extent, I guess, other people have. It's definitely hard crashed on me a few times, and it's like, oh, that was annoying. I'll just be like, oh, it's got time to
ain't
take a break.
Xbox shit, though?
I got a new one. I got that one died, like, took the shit to bed.
Yeah, you took it to bed?
Gotcha.
Oh, yellow?
Yeah, well, it's just sitting in the corner, just collecting dust.
Look at the flowers.
Yeah. It's like, think happy thoughts. Yeah. No, but, yeah, so I haven't encountered, I think, nearly as much issues, but it's definitely dumb shit. I was playing earlier, and, like, I was walking down the street, and there's a car in the sidewalk. Yeah. Like, just the top, like, just the top of the car is in there. I have issues where, like, I can't drive in first person. I don't like driving like that. So
yeah, I don't either.
I try to drive in third person.
It gets stuck.
But it won't move out from first person to third. So it's like, and it's fucking dumb, annoying. Like, if you use the tech gun, you know how to get that blue screen. Sometimes it should stay up there, and I switch the gun. Or sometimes if I pick up an item, you know, it'll display in the corner. Sometimes that shit'll stay there.
Sometimes it'd be late.
Or just be there. So I've had dumbass bugs and it's still buggy shit to the day. Yeah. Like, I still run into bugs. But I'm like damn near 50 hours in the game. I'm still having fun playing it.
Yeah, the game is fun to play, but it's just like, what game is perfect, you know, fresh out?
Yeah, but it shouldn't be this fucked
up. It shouldn't be this fucked up,
There's different, like, there's bugs, and then there's this shit.
Yeah, bugs, there's glitches, and there's cyberpunk.
Like, every Fallout game's been buggy and had weird shit. Even Witcher's been buggy. Like, fucking Red Dead be buggy. First Red Dead, like, the niggas was in cars flying in the sky.
Yeah.
That's why in Red Dead 2, they had, like, the thing where there's people that was flying because that was a bug in the first one. Like, so there's games have bugs, but this shit is
crazy.
Insane. Yeah.
Like, especially the chick was standing like this and shit. Oh, yeah.
Bitch, somebody trying to render you right now.
Yeah.
Couldn't render all the way in.
Which sucks because the game is fun to play.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It is. God damn.
Have you run across the talking gun?
No, but I saw that and that's cool.
Oh, yeah. So it's a talking gun?
Yeah, it's a gun.
Yeah. It's a gun that, like, auto aims or some shit.
Also, here's something that I saw in a video and I don't know if it's true. I got to do more research. Because when you pick up the gun, it asks you what option you want to set it to. It's like, kill mode, so all the shots is headshots. And then friendly mode is gonna just shoot niggas in the limbs automatically, so you can use it and it'll be non-lethal.
Yeah, it's like arm, leg, arm.
But whatever you pick after 50 kills, it switches to the opposite.
Oh shit.
So if you want it to be headshot only, pick friendly first, and then after 50 kills with friendly, it's gonna switch to headshot only. If you want friendly, start with headshot only and then switch over to friendly.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Pure dick shots.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of that, that's another glitch. What? I'm running around my dick out. Like, what the
what?
Because not a pants won't render.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Nigga, like, I think you set your character like that.
I ain't set it like that. I mean, I gave him the hammer, but still.
That motherfucker's cool attribute was like on fucking 10.
Yeah. Because you have to have, like, the dick stiff or flinging. So you go to the menu and let the shit, the flies out. You just go.
Nigga, all right. Walking up the bitches doing the helicopters.
Yeah. North Carolina. Take a shot up. Did it like a helicopter?
Is that the name of the episode? Helicopter?
Yes.
Nah. Oh, you gotta bring J-Watt back then.
He has to bring himself back. Nobody sent him nowhere but himself.
I know. I talked to him today.
Have y'all talked to him?
No, he don't talk to me no more. No. I'm telling you, he got mad at me for that.
Say I'm tripping. I ain't tripping.
He cool though.
Yeah, he cool.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. You gotta bring himself back. He welcome.
Yeah, you
just, you know.
Fuck with you, James. But
yeah.
You just. Oh, that was him? I fuck with you too, dog.
That'd be dope. That'd
be dope. It was him. I fuck with you too, dog.
That would be dope. Yeah. He did get mad at me about that shit, so.
Okay.
So I have not talked to him since.
Still got love for you, my nigga.
Yeah. He was cool.
You were just wilding that one day. Yeah. And I just couldn't take it.
A couple of days. A few days, but.
You wilding for like a month straight. I just couldn't take it no more. I was like, you know what? Somebody got to say some shit. And then it turned out to be me. I was trying not to say it, but it's like.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that specific thing. Yeah.
But, you know, it's in the past.
Is it though?
We can leave it in 2020.
Yeah. Can we though?
We can leave it in Cynthia. Ooh.
What?
Did we just get jinxed?
Leave it in Cynthia?
No, because Cynthia sent us a letter.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Did we get a letter from the year?
Yeah, we got
it. Oh, shit.
Yo, bitch, don't listen to our show no more.
No, please do. And thank you for putting your boyfriend on to our show.
Sorry, we named a fucking year after you.
Yeah, we didn't know any better.
Yeah.
Let's see. DC Marvel news. Justice Lee's Gal Gadot confirmed she had an onset issue with Joss Whedon. So, more and more people are coming out about this guy, and what do you think the repercussions are going to be?
I know. Well, she said in the article, she said that she had an issue, but it was resolved.
Mm-hmm.
So like, it's like whatever, they didn't say what the issue was, but it was resolved in that moment, or maybe while they're filming or whatever. So it wasn't as extensive as what maybe happened with Ray Fisher or whatever, but she did also have some type of issue. And so did Jason Momoa, apparently, and where he backed up Ray Fisher saying, yeah, the only people who haven't said anything are like Ezra Miller, Henry Cavill, and Ben Affleck.
Why do I think I know what it is?
What do you think it is, Bobby?
I think it, you remember when the Flash was laying on Wonder Woman's breath? He was like, oh.
No, I don't remember that. I'm gonna be honest with you, I watched the movie one time only, and I don't remember.
Yeah, right.
And like, I watched it again.
It was a scene where the Flash saved Wonder Woman. He was like just laying on his breath. Like, oh, man, she probably was like, why you got that scene here? Why is this here?
It's a good place to lay. Is that anything? The fuck?
I'm just an actor doing my duty.
I'm just an actor doing my duty. He didn't care, but I wouldn't care.
Luke Cage star Mike Coulter says he's not discussed Marvel Return. Good.
Damn, nigga.
I know you got no love for that nigga.
I don't like him as Luke Cage, no.
We know.
Damn, I do not.
We noticed.
There was one. Who was the dude? The original Punisher?
Oh, Thomas Jane.
Yeah, Thomas Jane. He wanted to direct the Punisher movie with John Bernthal.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Saw that.
I mean, that's if they bring him back. That'd be cool.
I'm with that.
Hey! Definitely with all that shit.
I mean, is Thomas Jane a good director? Because
we don't know.
So it's a cool like
I gotta
thing,
check this shit out.
But I want them to get the right person for the job.
We can give him a chance. If it's wag, it's wag. We can just say that, hey, that didn't count towards the lore.
We don't got time to make mistakes like that.
We already had a Punisher movie. He was in it. It sucked. Maybe he knows.
I like that movie.
Yeah, me too. That movie wasn't.
It
like
wasn't
that.
Bad, but it wasn't.
But I'm talking about that was pre MCU, nigga. That was before MCU. After MCU, we ain't got time to make mistakes like that, nigga.
Okay, so he's been in the role. He knows what it takes. He knows what it encompasses. I'm pretty sure he does some type of research on the thing.
We lost these characters because the Netflix deal went blah. Yeah. So I need them to make, if they bring these characters back, we gotta bring them back, and it has to be good. Otherwise,
right,
it's just gonna probably make a longer time before we get another one. Because if it's not good, then we're like, oh well, it didn't make any money. Another 10 years before we do this again. So I want, if they do that, I want it to be good. Not saying that Thomas Jane couldn't make a good movie. I'm just saying, yeah, it's nice he played the character. Yada yada. No, get the right person for the right job.
Right.
That's my only thing.
Who knows? Who the fuck knows? Hey.
But Donnie.
Where are the topics? Let's see. Juggernaut is officially a hero, but he's still just as deadly.
Juggernaut.
So when you got Juggernaut, do you really need anybody else?
No, not really.
Like that get like you put Colossus out of a job, you put fucking Wolverine out of a job. I mean, he really can't be killed unless he takes his helmet off. Well, he can't be hurt unless he takes his helmet off.
No, is he still that powerful? Maybe they nerfed him.
Yeah, he's still powerful.
Yeah, oh, okay.
He's still unstoppable.
Okay. So,
we'll juggernaut.
You don't really need anybody else. So, does hero mean he's part of the X-Men or he's just a good guy?
I think I saw something with him being on the Avengers, but I don't know if that was... I didn't read the thing all the way through.
Whoa. Juggernaut on the Avengers?
I mean, that's happened. They had a...
Now, Hulk and him got a fucking fight.
Talk it out.
Cause nigga, you can't have two strong. How you gonna have two of the same niggas on the team? Like, I don't need one of y'all.
Hulk and Thor is on the same team. What the fuck you talking about?
You said who?
Hulk and Thor.
Yeah, but he's a god versus a gamma radiation cancer nigga. I mean, Juggernaut in Hulk. I don't need two strong niggas going into battle wrecking shit.
Cancer nigga, my nigga.
I mean, he did have radiation.
Yeah, you know they use radiation like X-ray and shit. You don't have to have cancer for that.
Well, he got a mini series. I'm gonna get that.
I'm sorry.
Is that the fault of my stars, Hulk, or some shit?
Damn.
Nah, but I don't need two strong niggas on my team.
Well, Hulk is kind of loose cannon.
Is he?
He's not really controlled like that.
It depends on how they write him, but yeah. He just Hulk smash. Hulk do what he want.
Right. Juggernaut fought World Breaker Hulk, and it was a stalemate.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, shit.
Yeah. All right, well. I mean, I guess we can
look
see
at Bobby
that
out here.
Yeah.
And let's see, last but not least, Marvel confirms Black Panther star Chadwick Boseman for multiple episodes of MCU's What If.
Makes sense.
So they're using his likeness as a part of What If.
That, and I'm assuming he probably recorded his
voiceover
stuff already.
I'm
assuming that was already done in a
can. He got a movie out too. That's on Netflix now.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yep. Last one?
Mm-hmm. That we know of, yeah. But yeah, shout out to Marvel for doing this, but not knowing that, he was gonna
Yeah, I mean, pass away. The show's coming out, so it's like, what can we do? We can't take him out, because I'm sure it's probably integral to whatever the story is. So
They were saying that before, how they got, you know, the people to do voiceovers of their characters in the movie. So, you know, it makes sense. I'm glad they did this, you know, one last ode to Chadwick. I'm pretty sure they're going to make it extra special and extra, like, sentimental.
I'm sure it'll be like a little message or something for
him. It's going to be something crazy.
So I'm guessing this will end up being the last thing we hear him in, I guess. That's new.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, man. That's episode of the fucking year, man.
Yeah.
We made it through the fucking year, man.
Yeah.
Only one person got sick, man.
Yeah.
That's it, you know.
Twice.
Yeah. Twice, yeah.
Twice.
Because of football.
Yeah, cause for some football.
Motherfucking football.
Tell you right now, I'm not doing another Zoom episode ever.
I mean, we might have to. It may come up where we would have to do that. So don't say
you want to know what the episodes I hated the most?
All the Zoom episodes.
I hated all them shits.
I'm sure you did. Really?
I hate recording in my house. I hate being like being here is my escape. You know, I work all week. It's not like escape from my kids and shit, but it's like I work all week and I get to come here and just let loose and talk shit for however many hours. But being at home is just like I'm just home.
Mm. Yeah, but you're home talking shit.
Yeah, but then they hear me talking shit.
So that's where the problem is.
Kids. Oh, fuck kids.
I fucking love you, but I hate you.
Yeah. Y'all got a favorite episode of the year? A favorite moment of the year?
Ask the man with the fucking memory of a goldfish that I remember what episodes we did this year.
What about you, chat? Y'all got a favorite episode or favorite moment of the year?
This year?
Yeah.
Let me even see what was this year. I mean, I got to see what was even this year.
Memorable was Kobe. Live.
Oh, yeah. That was like February.
That was early. That was like
early.
Two or three episodes before the shutdown.
I got one, but I can't think of it. Oh, what the fuck was it?
The episode after Kobe was pretty funny. That was the whole Mark Sinclair shit. That was the
Waspinator.
was that this year?
Oh, that was this year. Yo, it seemed like so long ago.
Yep, Black Mamba. Yeah, because I think our first one back was with Rob. Yep.
Yeah, with Rob Markman.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's
the hip hop gamer.
That's with whatchamacallit? What's the game we used to play?
Head Bopper, Crime Stopper?
Yeah, Crime Stopper, Head Bopper. Yep. That went horribly wrong.
Yeah, just because we weren't in G Studio for
that. Yeah, they didn't know how to fucking work shit.
No, they did not.
The interviews was cool this year. Shout out to Rob. I gotta look at this shit because I don't know.
Rob, Hip Hop Gamer. Chris and Tamara.
Funniest.
Damn, that was
this year. Damn, that was this year. Wasn't
January.
It?
Shit. That seems like
that was a good one.
That was a real good one, actually.
That was a good one because Tamara didn't know that she was going to participate. I was gonna make her fucking participate. Like, yo, you here? I know you got a story. I know you got something to say. But that was kind of impromptu. Like I said, y'all not going to get a lot of those Friday episodes, Saturday episodes often. Mm. You know, Chris just happened to be in town.
Fuck, that's the only one we ever did.
That's the only one we ever did, but we don't really have, like, guests that come to the studio like that. Yeah. Most of the interviews are, you know, over the phone because it's people from, you know, just all over the place who don't want to come to Connecticut or don't have no business here.
And we had Steve on.
Yeah.
Oh.
Human White Man.
Also, even though it's like 3 weeks late, congratulations to Steve.
Oh yeah.
He's having a fucking kid. He's having a son.
Shout out to Steve.
And every time I meant to fucking say this shit, my brain always made me forget. And I'd be like, oh yeah, I meant to say something, but congratulate to him.
Yeah, Steve is having a child.
Go to A Pot Amongst Men on Instagram or whatever and congratulate him.
I don't know that he's having a boy
He's having a boy, so he's having another human white man.
Yeah.
He's making more of them.
So yeah, Rob Markman, Hip Hop Gamer, Tamara, Chris,
Hilton.
Hilton,
Mr. Wobble.
Yeah, Mr. Wobble.
Yeah, that was a good one too.
We had a 2-year anniversary. That was a good Zoom call.
We learned a lot.
Yeah, we learned a lot. Did I say this on air?
What?
How about I researched the wrong Mr. Wobble?
Oh yeah.
I don't know if you said it on air. I don't remember that.
So yeah, so we had an interview with Mr. Wobble, right? And you know, me with my research for interviews, I'm just looking up stuff on YouTube. So I'm looking up Mr. Wobble. I'm thinking he's like, you know, something like that. This nigga gets on screen, it's a totally different nigga.
It's a white man.
So every question I asked that man was all impromptu. Like I knew nothing about that man. I just knew that he was a wrestler and he made the dance. Like I found all that shit out on the show live with y'all. Yeah. Jax.
Yeah. That was good
Jax.
Too. Didn't like your third Kevin Eastman. Was this your first one?
Second or third.
Yeah.
Milo the Cat.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Who else?
Artho?
Hilton. Yeah, Artho Isom from Dr. Stagio.
Mark Cooper.
Mark Cooper.
Second interview, I believe.
Yeah. Crondon, that went horribly wrong for episode 100. We hit 100 episodes this year. That was a milestone.
That was big.
I don't know how many podcasts, you know, hit 100 episodes, especially in Connecticut. I don't know that many podcasts that have done this shit.
Yeah, did we win anything that from month? That thing?
Hell no.
I don't even think this shit started yet. I don't know what the fuck happened.
Why'd they do that shit so early then?
They stupid. They don't know how to run shit. Let's see.
And we better win because that's all mad niggas in there.
Hell yeah.
Putting them three ninjas. And we better at least get a nomination, nigga.
Tatiana King.
Yep.
Shout out to her. Christy St. Martin of Gamers.Vote.
Yep.
Shout out to her.
Third Kevin Eastman interview.
Yeah. That's the shit with this show. It's people I'm talking to I'd have never imagined or wanted to talk to. That, you know, it just happens to work out that way. You know, we've been doing this show for. Going on, well, next year it'll be three years.
And February 16th,
it'll be 3 years. Yeah, it's a lot has happened.
Yeah,
we sold a lot of merch this year. You know, connected with a bunch of people. We didn't. What the fuck is this?
It's Discord.
Discord. Yeah. Yeah, we opened up Discord.
Yeah.
And we got to know more of y'all intimately.
Good or bad,
yeah. Dilla asked what happened with James. So what happened was, right, not to get into too much detail, but we was in Discord, and for like a month or so, maybe like more than that, like he was just wild, and it was just obscene comments, it was pictures. I was just like, whoa, 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 chill, relax. And then it was just one day where I wasn't feeling it. And then, like, I kind of like balked him when I didn't meet. I kind of did like a Tom Cruise.
Yeah, you kind of Tom Cruise.
I kind of Tom Cruised it.
Yeah. My thing was something different.
Yeah, and he just wound up leaving Discord acting like, well, we kind of attacked him. Yeah.
I don't think.
Yeah, not
personally, but if he felt like
I can see how you could take it personal.
Yeah,
but
and that was the first time then I think that he came back
then
after
he came
a while.
Back and then he left.
And then he left after that fucking conversation.
Yeah, then he got into it with somebody in Discord, and I tried to kick him out, and I wind up like banning him from Discord. But
and then when we had that conversation, and that's when he left.
Yeah, that's when he left too.
I think that's the last time he was in there.
Dark said all the times Hesh and Dom and Hesh go back and forth about Pokemon. Yeah, because nigga can't beat. I'm the fucking champ.
I can't beat you, but I literally beat you, and you said it didn't fucking count.
Because it didn't count.
Because you don't want to talk about that. But you want to talk about that shit? How I waxed your ass, right? Well, and it didn't fucking count.
First of all. Hold your fucking horses. That's how you talk to me, first of all. Second of all, I think that episode we said it, but it just didn't count. I think I acknowledged that you did beat me.
I don't. I don't hear a lot of that. I just hear a lot of. I just hear, huh? I don't hear.
Yeah, you hear that fucking metal clip. Yeah. I'm still the champ, though.
I don't hear when I whoop that ass, nigga.
Nigga, get your money out. We can do a no smoke. I whoop your ass again. I'm ready for you. Right. Champ ain't scared.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Where your belt at?
Hmm?
What are you about at?
Right there. You just keeping it warm for me.
I'm keeping it warm. Oh, okay.
Yeah, just, you know. I need somewhere to put it.
You need somewhere to put it?
Yeah.
Put it right back on my shoulder. How about that, bitch?
Yeah, you can enjoy it while it lasts, nigga.
I will.
The fuck?
But, yeah, man. You know, a lot has happened this year. What have y'all learned anything from 2020, like, as a whole?
People are stupid.
Yeah.
But I knew that. I guess I really know it now.
Yeah, humans. I think we're allowed too much freedom as humans. I think
it's so much shit. It's like niggas is dumb.
Yeah,
niggas is dumb.
I learned anything this year?
Yeah, have you learned anything?
I learned to appreciate things a lot more because what was taken away, you know, the option of going outside and going places, being stuck in the house for so long.
Yeah.
It's now starting to make me go crazy, you know. I've learned to appreciate, even though I hate my job, I appreciate my job because we found out who was essential and who wasn't to society.
That is true. Even though I did spend the majority of the beginning of this episode shitting on my job, I am also thankful that I still have a job.
Word.
And I was able to, you know, I ain't make a whole lot of money, but I was able to survive versus how other people was living, so let me not be so ungrateful.
Yeah, I just learned to appreciate shit way more because the shit I went through with my daughter, just shit that's been going on with this year in general. Enough. You know, people that have caught COVID and have passed away, people that, you know, have these symptoms of COVID still. Mm. It's just crazy out here, and this shit is not slowing down whatsoever. But, you know, hopefully 2021 will bring us, you know, more positivity.
Yeah, you know, and all that cliche shit when somebody dies, you know, yeah. Life is short.
Yeah, life is short and all that stuff.
Never know. Tell people you love them because you never know the last time you talk to them.
Tell people you love them. Never know.
All that shit, you know, which is true, and even though no one ever does it. But yeah. But I guess the sentiment is nice, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Or to at least feel that way.
You know, the dojo shows up when they need to.
Yeah, now shout out to, you know, all the, you know, I mean, obviously, shout out to y'all.
Yeah,
all the people in the Twitch, all the people who fuck with, like, because obviously, you wouldn't be able to do this without y'all. It wouldn't make sense to be doing this if we didn't have people who actually gave a fuck to listen. Like, so.
Dark said, humans are dumb. Aliens would kill us all so easily. And Thanos was right.
And he's actually correct.
Oh, speaking of that, wasn't Israel talking about they had contact with aliens?
I saw that.
To be Galactic Empire or something?
I have no idea how. Yeah, yeah, I saw that.
I was thinking about that. Like, why would they contact us in Israel? Like, what the fuck's so special about us?
You're not ready yet. So we just fall it back. I mean, yeah, watch out, niggas. Still,
like, didn't Jesus come from Israel? So maybe Jesus was an alien. Man, they went back to where they found him.
Yo, if when they do the countdown of the new year, if some if a meteor come, if like Jesus come back, if some, I would not be surprised. I'd be just like, oh shit, I'm about to film this.
Yeah, that will. Yeah.
Not surprised at shit.
Oh, niggas got Christmas plans, New Year's plans?
Nope. Nah. I ain't got a plan in the world because I think the cases are gonna spike up second week of January because I think people are tired of being in the house. So I think people are going to go out for New Year's. They're going to have some type of illegal small gathering. Somebody going to get sick, and then it's just going to super spread. Christmas, not doing much. You know, kids, food, family. Yeah. No, ain't doing much. You're opening gifts.
Yeah,
did y'all get anything for Christmas? I don't.
I mean, Christmas hasn't happened yet.
No, but so are people getting you stuff that you know of? Like,
I'm sure my parents are gonna buy something. Like, I'm gonna get socks or something, nigga. Like, socks, a hoodie. Look, hey, it's something, nigga. I'll take a gift, nigga. Whatever.
I guess.
Nah, I don't, cause I don't really do the gift stuff with my friends anymore. I ordered a gift for my goddaughter.
It hasn't
whether the fuck or not it shows up is a whole nother experience. Because I ordered this shit on the 11th. And even when I ordered it, it said it's coming on the 23rd, which is stupid to me.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then when I checked the whatever, because I ordered off Walmart, I checked on Walmart and it says it's in New York. And it's been in New York since like the 14th.
Oh, yeah.
And then I would try to check FedEx with the shipping number, but then FedEx is like, yo, your tracking number don't exist.
Is it valid? Yeah. Oh, yeah, somebody swiped that shit.
Well, that's unfortunate. So she might not be getting a gift on Christmas for me, which sucks.
Yeah.
I don't know, but my friend did invite me to go over to their house on Christmas, and I'm trying to find a good excuse to not.
You should go. Just like you hung out with your cousins and sat in Discord, you should actually converse with people and talk. And just, I want better for you, my nigga.
Okay. I don't know what to do. How am I supposed to respond to that? I don't know what I'm supposed to say.
I don't know, but I don't want you to later in your life be regretting like, damn, I should have did this, did that, said this, been here, did this. I'm telling you, yo, once you get to that point, you're going to be too old and be like, damn, this what I was missing out on when I was in my bubble? I just want you to share yourself, Hesh. People like you. You're a good guy. Okay, I try. You be a piece of shit if you want. Thank you to the dojo, man.
Yes, no, seriously. Obviously, we get, you know, it's the same sentimental mush every time we get to the year. The three, you know, we'll be saying the same shit in February.
Yeah,
you know, but it's same like when we hit 150, when we hit, would it be 200?
But I'm just like appreciative of what we built. So far, you know, you don't get into I didn't get into this thing and like, oh, we gonna have like listeners from all over the country, all over the world, and they're gonna buy the fucking merch that we put out, and they're gonna listen to us, and we say like, hey, we gonna be live on Twitch, and these niggas actually show up.
So, it's one of them things, like, obviously talking about, oh, it's something I want to do, let's do podcasts, and like, yes, you want this shit to be successful, but then you don't actually think about all the shit that actually entails. Like, so it's like, oh shit, people actually listen and hear the dumb shit I say and laugh at it.
Yeah, like Ski said in the chat, like, I guess we help lighten people's mood when they're having like a bad week. So we just happen to put out these episodes, don't know what they do.
Yeah.
And they just go out into the universe and it's just like, here, consume our bullshit for 2 hours.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we just come back and do it every week. And, you know, we've been
consistent. I don't even think have we missed a.
We haven't missed a week. I've missed mad episodes.
Yeah, you missed mad. Well, you missed like five
this year. I think last year I might have missed like one.
Yeah. Mm. I don't think I've missed a show yet.
Nah.
I don't think Bobby's missed a show yet either.
Nah, I missed one. Nah. It was one? When I went to New York. Well, that was kind of conjoined.
Oh, yeah, he did miss one.
Yeah, he did miss
one. But technically, I didn't because it was conjoined.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, because we filmed.
Oh, yeah, we traveled back in time.
Yeah. Came back. Yeah, I forgot about that.
I was in the quantum realm.
Yeah. I forgot about that. Yeah.
Taking a break. Fuck y'all niggas. 121 episodes, nigga.
I think Bobby couldn't find like a babysitter or some shit.
Yeah, it was something. Yeah, something stupid. Yeah.
But yeah, man, it's just, you know.
I mean.
It's a fucking dojo, man.
120. This is episode 121.
Episode 121.
121 episodes.
I don't know what the fuck next year is gonna bring.
Who would have thunk?
Do y'all have guests that you want to be on the show next year?
Bill Lamar. I tried to get him. He'd fucking dub me. Tara Strong tried to get it. She'd fucking dub me.
Mm.
Those two I definitely want because Harley Quinn and fucking every other black voice in the world.
Yeah.
Mm. Bill Lamar.
I definitely want to try to get T-Pain on here. That's a fucking street. That's a reach.
That's a reach.
That's a reach. But him getting into this gaming space is intriguing to me.
Yeah. Phil Paulson, I believe, right?
Rob Paulson,
that's what I meant. Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely want to talk to Rob Paulson. Phil Lamar is a good one. I want to try to get some directors on here. I want to try to get somebody that's in the esports world in here too.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Got one last question, no pressure, but is there any chance you guys have time for a best of compilation? That'll probably come soon.
I could try to do that. So here's the thing.
Yeah.
If y'all could like send me like episodes and maybe a timestamp where you think something, because
yeah.
It's like I could try to do it and I'll try to do it, but I don't want to make no promises because I don't.
Oh yeah, Mark from RDC World, I want to talk to him too.
Yeah. It's just going through a whole episode, finding the thing that was actually funny in that, because yeah. I don't remember shit.
Then y'all got to tell us what was funny. Oh, Black Flip was fucking hilarious.
Black Flip
was hilarious, my nigga.
So that's got to go up there. That's one.
That's got to be in there.
But yeah, I think, actually, yeah, because we're going to be on break for a while, so I think that should be something.
Yeah, if y'all could, if y'all do want that, if y'all have like a favorite moment or episode, and if y'all know around about what the time is so we can find it and put the compilation together, that'll help.
Just to make life easier.
Yeah, because, you know, three men with, you know, families and full-time jobs, it's kind of hard to sit down at a computer and just be like, all right, let's skim through episode one of this year.
3 hours and two hours, and there's 100 and at this point probably 130 hours worth of audio.
Yeah.
140 hours worth of audio, so it's, you know.
Yeah, somebody said at the beginning, am I going to be as lit as I was on episode 100? I planned on drinking too, but I just didn't get to the liquor store.
It's snowing and shit. You don't
want to.
Yeah,
better
it started snowing and shit. I was like, let me just get straight here. I ain't had nowhere to park when I fucking got here.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, my car got stuck. I'm hoping I can get out.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
There's one director I'm going to try to get, but it might be damn near impossible.
Who?
Like the dude who he directed on The Mandalorian, Rick Famuyiwa.
Nothing is impossible.
Not from Bobby.
Nigerian dude. He directed the episode with Bill Burr.
Oh, where?
Shit.
Okay, yeah, cool.
Yeah, he wrote it too.
Yeah,
that's dope.
Matter of fact, speaking of Bill Burr, I want to try to get some comedians on here too.
That'd be cool. I mean, if you hit up Steve, he interviews a bunch of comedians. I know they're like Jersey locals probably, but
yeah,
maybe get in contact with a few of them.
Yeah, I'll talk to Steve and see what's up. But yeah, it's a few guests I got in mind that, you know, hopefully.
I heard somebody else in the back of my head, but my brain is.
Ernie Reyes got to hit me back though.
Yeah,
that'd be cool.
Hopefully he hit me back. But yeah, we gonna work on some more guests. Y'all got a favorite guest this year?
Favorite guest?
Mr. Wobbles was cool because he was just like an interesting ass dude.
Cool, he
was like
a white boy.
He just lived a life working in strip clubs and just doing shit. I was like, oh, that was cool.
He invented a fucking black dance.
Invented the Wobble. Like, I think Rob Markman, that was cool.
Yeah.
Because he was writing a comic book for the first time, so that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, went to New York, and that was just interesting to.
Yeah, it's an interesting setup. Yeah.
Unfortunately, the audio wasn't the greatest for that episode.
Xavier Woods.
That would be cool.
That'd be cool.
If we could get him.
Yeah.
If we do shit like that, I'd like.
Yeah, we definitely want to talk to Bootios.
Yeah, like, wanna, big booty
That'd be cool to get like Adam Sessler or some shit like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, somebody from G4.
Olivia Munn, if you.
Nah, you nasty.
You don't want to talk to Olivia Munn, nigga? God damn. I can't just be interested in what she got to say.
That's a reach, though. We ain't gonna get.
I know. Yeah. Listen, we just talking now.
Yeah.
What you talking? We just saying words. We just spitballing, throwing out ideas to God.
Yeah. I mean, definitely. So
I may not be Aaron Rodgers, but you know what I mean,
Ernie raises a possibility. He see this shit. It's just like, come on, man.
Yeah,
come
just answer my shit, man. Come on, man. Fuck.
Definitely ask him out.
Who else?
Are
there any people out there that y'all fuck with that y'all would chat, like us to chat on?
Nah, Dark said Mark from RDC. Robbie said Xavier Woods.
Okay.
Let's see what the chat talking about.
Like, if they're the like two. super like. Famous is gonna be obviously way harder.
They super popping or not?
No, it's gonna be harder for us to. They might not want to come on the show. Right?
Yeah,
they might not. Or they might dub you.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. So like, I mean, we shoot for some of them niggas, but we never know. Like,
yeah, shoot your shot. That's all you gotta do.
I'm gonna get Michael B on the show for Dom to talk to. They can air out his grievances.
I don't hate that nigga.
I'm gonna get him and Kevin Hart at the same time so we can talk to both of them niggas at the same damn time.
I don't hate neither of them niggas. I might dislike Kevin Hart more than Michael B, but it's like, I don't hate. I don't got a problem with none of them. It's just, if I could tell Kevin Hart to his face that his stand up and comedy sucks now, that'd be cool.
That's the wording you want to go with?
Yeah.
Nah, I wouldn't word it like that. Oh, okay. But you know. I don't know how to talk to people a lot of times.
I would. You gotta be honest, man. Like,
no, I mean, sometimes you gotta just take the blunt approach.
Nah,
he know what he doing.
He know what he not doing too. He's being funny. But Kevin Hart.
What is somebody else out there that my brain is like?
You got hit with a compliment, then.
Yeah.
Disrespect. Love your movies.
Are there any people in like the games journalism world like y'all would like to fuck with or talk to?
That's how you get in the back door of shit. You start hitting up these article writers from like IGN and shit like that. I want to get somebody from. Damn, like that's why I wish I had my original Twitter. Somebody from Screen Rant, a writer, a chick, just following me. Damn it!
Well, I don't know. We could talk to some of the on-screen talent from IGN. You know, the Rooster Teeth people.
If it makes sense.
Matter of fact,
a few game developers. I really want to talk to the dude that is like the head of Cyberpunk.
Oh yeah, that nigga's a ghost.
The black dude, yeah, that nigga's a ghost.
Yeah. That's the guy who created Cyberpunk. That's
yeah.
Not the game, but
the
board game.
Yeah, the board
game first, or pen and paper or whatever.
Yeah, I want to talk to him.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, what did y'all do this week? Because out of nowhere, I started getting mad comedians and podcasts following me.
Oh shit!
I just be sharing and sharing mad shit, nigga.
I was like,
niggas just be watching your page. Niggas find your page like in the
yeah.
Cause you got that shit on Instagram, Explore page. Yeah, they just be finding your shit.
Cause you got mad followers.
Nah, it's on Twitter though.
Well, you got mad followers on Twitter, probably.
I don't like when comedians follow me because I feel like they're trying to steal my jokes.
They probably are, nigga.
That's what happens.
You untalented ass bastards. Fuck out of here.
Fiona from Rooster Teeth.
That could be cool.
That'd be cool.
She's funny. She's cool.
Yeah, man. I want to talk to some streamers too. So hopefully
there's a few of them out there, probably.
There's a few of them out there. Somebody that's in the Facebook gaming world, somebody on the Twitch streaming world.
I would like to do a female one, but it gotta be both.
I don't want to talk to none of them big titty.
I want to talk to them though.
There's other.
I know there's women out there that, you know, who? There's a couple I follow, matter of fact. Let me see my list.
Yeah, see your list. Who's on your list?
Yeah, because the state of Twitch right
now.
Following?
I'm going to see who you following.
I follow Pokimane. I follow this black girl called Story Mode Bay.
I don't use Twitch, so
this girl that plays Pokemon named Sierra Dawn. Yeah, that's it. For women.
Those three.
Yeah,
man. I just wanna, you know, branch out to more people. Hopefully I can get my streaming set up sometime next year. Spending $10,000 on a computer is stupid, right?
$10,000? Hell yeah.
Okay. Right now, yeah, probably. Okay, I would say that is probably a little extreme.
All
right. I understand where your mind is at.
But it's because you
barely home as
you,
it is.
You're just starting, so it's
So maybe just get to the bare minimum just to see if you even like consistently. Cool. And then maybe spend a little more. Because
that's just the PC.
Then
I got to get all
the
shit.
I know, you said PC.
Yeah.
You didn't say nothing about camera.
Camera, light.
Deck.
Oh, desk.
Yeah. Just a $10,000. I mean, if you got it, I suppose.
I mean. No, I don't. But
I think that's the other thing we got. That's just inside baseball. I think going forward, we got to try to figure something out to maybe have a more consistent presence on Twitch.
I mean, we can start doing more of the episodes live.
I mean, that's a start.
Seems to get a good reaction.
Yeah. And then we got to do something for Patreon. We got to figure something out.
We got to figure something out. Like I said, No Smokes is coming back. I want to try to bring back the hashtags on Instagram, too, but that takes a lot of work. Other than that, man, all I got. Y'all got picks?
Schultz,
y'all want to give some shit away?
We got anything to give away? Sure.
I don't know.
If we got something to give away, absolutely. I don't know if we got anything to give away, though.
Yeah, I don't know how to pick a winner if we did get some shit away, but we'll figure it out. Picks, man.
Oh, Schultz Saves America?
You watched it, all four of them? Yes. All four of them, right?
Yeah, it's all at least three I watched.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's good?
I like him. You know, if you watch any of his Instagram videos that he was doing, it's essentially that.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
But on Netflix, which is a...
Is it an hour?
They're like 20 minutes.
About. Oh, okay.
There's about maybe a little more, 16 to 20 minutes. Not too long, but you know, because it's rapid fire. But, it's funny, so it's like the joke within the joke with the way he phrases the word, and then there's usually like a gag within the picture that they're showing. If you like Andrew Schultz and you like that shit, I think
you'll
enjoy
it. Oh, he does
it
on YouTube.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's basically that, but it's longer form, and it's on Netflix, which is a big deal, because you got Netflix bag.
Yeah.
And, you know what I mean? So good looks to him.
Right. All right. So Show Saves America on Netflix. Bobby, what you got?
Big Mouth Season 4.
Oh, I got to watch that.
Oh, is that really good?
Yeah. There was something.
I think my girl was telling me about that.
Yeah, there was something that somebody wanted us to talk about.
What?
Like, code switch it.
Oh, yeah. No, that's what was real.
It's a real thing. Yeah. It's a real.
But people were offended. Real. People were offended.
Who the fuck?
You know.
Deaf people offended. White people offended. Black people offended. It's
serious topic. You joking about it. Nigga, we joke about that. What
are
you talking about?
He just made a song to explain to your dumbass white people that don't understand what code switching is.
Yeah.
That's really what it is. They made it palatable for you so that you understand, like, hey, depending on the circumstance and situation that I'm in that I have to speak to people a certain way just because that's how I've grown up to learn to function in the world.
I wake up with ice breath tomorrow, you white people in trouble.
Oh, I cannot wait.
I swear to God.
I'm getting stupid active. I want to get teleportation like in Jumper so I can just teleport to anywhere in the world.
Nigga, if I wake up on fire, I swear to God.
I'm getting dumb active, nigga.
Active.
Nigga, there's a people bank. There's two people banks on my on the street, up the street from me. Both of them getting done in.
Damn. You want to charge me overdraft fees?
Overdraft this? <Yeah. laughs> Fucking get Magneto powers, pull the fucking vault door off like, take all that money.
I want to be hit from Dragon Ball Super. Shit. Hell yeah.
Oh, shit.
What happened? Who died?
Nobody died, but
nobody's name today.
Disney hasn't been paying Star Wars writers earnings for years.
Yeah, damn. So they've been writing all this fire shit for free?
I guess they don't give you royalties or nothing.
Oh.
Damn.
Well,
that's
shitty.
Does that work?
Is that a contract thing?
I don't know what it is, but you know how George Lucas was. He'll just give somebody the shit. Like, oh, okay, write it. I don't know how that shit switched with the whole Disney merger.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's crazy.
I have to look into that because I don't know.
Damn, nigga.
That's an accusation.
You can't live off that? Shit.
Oh, that's crazy.
And my pick is, I don't know when they did this, but Netflix put this this X-Men anime style thing on their platform. It used to come on G4, matter of fact.
It did.
Yeah, so that's on Netflix now. So
I think that just recently got put up.
Yeah. I don't know when they did it though.
Yeah.
It might have been like last week or two, but I just saw it and I was like, oh shit, I used to watch this on G4. But it was dope from what I remember back in what, like 02, 01?
Something like that.
But yeah, it's dope.
That's the one with Armor in it, right?
Huh?
Armor was in that? The Japanese girl?
Yeah.
Yeah, Armor, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But yeah, watch that on Netflix. Other than that, man, what else we got?
I think that's it.
That really it?
Yeah. I believe so. We done did another one.
Oh,
sorry. All right, so Dojo, thank you. We love you. Another year in the books. Appreciate y'all, motherfuckers. You don't even know how much. But after this, we going on break. So you know, check out them previous episodes. You know, in case you miss it, we might do a year in recap. We might do that compilation thing. Who the fuck knows? But
The
Dojo, we appreciate you. We fuck with you. Fuck with all y'all. Appreciate y'all for coming in alive. Appreciate y'all listening every Wednesday, or whenever the fuck we decide to put the episode out.
Yeah.
Either morning or night.
Yeah.
Appreciate y'all for sticking around.
The 13th we'll be back.
13th
of January.
13th of January we'll be back.
Yeah, so expect a new episode January 13th.
Until then, don't call us, don't hit us for shit.
Unless the world blows up on January 1st.
Damn.
Yeah.
Or I get superpowers.
This show is done if I get superpowers.
So, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be a supervillain now.
Yeah, yeah.
See the fat on TV.
Think of more anti-hero, not villain.
Oh no, I'm murking shit.
I'm not a good guy. I'm not with Professor X or nothing like that. I'm just don't tolerate bullshit.
I'm stealing things and I'm murking shit. Yeah. Taking all the shit.
So you shoot your eye out.
You'll shoot your eye out, kid. Merry Christmas.
But yeah, man. On that note.
Ho, ho.
Like you said. So. Till next year, man. Ninja Vanish. We out of here. See my belt trying to leave me?
Yeah, because it's coming over to me. Because, yeah, go home to
nah,
me. Yeah.
Nah, hold
yeah.
you me.
Nah, for now.
Fuck out of here.
Always make bad decisions sometimes, nigga. It's all good.
Deck the halls with vials of holly.
La, la, la,
la, la, la, la, la, la. Tis the season to be jolly. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. You.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal. And a Happy New Year.